We are live. We have launched another global transmission for the next 4 hours here today. Michael Savage was going to be on for an hour, but he had to reschedule. He's on next Wednesday, I believe. I'm going to get Paul Watson on to talk about an article up on Infowars.com with video, with a bunch of other videos. And this is with Germans themselves clapping. The Green Party has said similar things. A Muslim scholar celebrates extinction, quote, of blue-eyed, blonde-haired Germans. You see, this is an anti-white, anti-European agenda. And it's being done to just absolutely collapse the West. And they're bringing in the most incompatible people you can imagine. It is simply, absolutely over the top. Political correctness gets you to turn off your own instincts, turn off your own life force, turn off your own common sense, and to make your new identity one of self-loathing and cultural suicide. And I have an entire spectrum of news along these lines today illustrating this that we're going to be breaking down. We have images of the Paris train station that looks like anywhere else in the world but Europe, and then a shot of the Russian train stations. Just to illustrate, can you imagine what people say in Nigeria or people in Brazil or people anywhere else would say if suddenly their country was like this and their country was offering, quote, all this free welfare to bring the third world populations there to then dip them into political correctness. This is Paris we're showing on screen for radio listeners. And then you cut to Moscow, and it looks European. And this, again, would not be an issue if the groups being brought in were not being taught by the colleges and by the universities and by the schools and by the entire culture that you are here to destroy the culture. Folks used to want to come to the West to adopt some of the culture, the free market, the choices, the wealth, the technology. But the globalists want to get rid of that and only have it on controlled government and corporate reservations. Everyone else without is in a giant gulag, basically. A giant ghetto, like what the Nazis did in Poland and other areas, putting their political enemies in these compact cities. That is the admitted plan. Meanwhile, there's a big story out in the UK Express. 80% of Brits would be happy to quit the UK for Russia after Putin offers free land. Almost 8 out of 10 citizens would seriously consider quitting Britain and immigrating to Russia, a poll by Express has revealed. Now, let's stop right there. They called it an apocalypse. In fact, we've got the article from yesterday. I forgot to cover it. In the major papers in Italy, that they have a 1.3% reproduction rate. For every 2 adults, they have 1.3 children. And trendies will go, how does people have 1.3? It's in the aggregate. It's in the sum of hundreds of millions of people. It's not even hundreds of millions now in Italy. Because of the modern culture, the modern programming, turning off the life force, the subliminal messages, the taxes, the regulations, what the TV sells, that having kids are horrible. And they're calling it an apocalypse. Italy faces a population implosion apocalypse, and Italy is doubling tax rebates for you to have kids. So is Russia. But it's only Italy and Russia that aren't trying to commit suicide. They're dead already. But they just realize they're dead. They're trying to flop around in pools of societal blood and try to get up on their knees. Now, in Germany, the UK and other areas, the political class has the bleeding culture on the ground, ramming double-edged daggers thousands of times, foaming at the mouth with trendy, helping pull the dagger in. And we have kicked off another global broadcast. I'm Alex Jones, your host. Thank you so much for joining us. It's Tuesday, the 17th day of May, 2016. We'll be live here for the next 4 hours. We're going to have open phones throughout the broadcast. We have David Knight honchoing the fourth hour as well. I'll be here for the next 3 hours. All right, let me attempt this again right at the start. We've always failed, but today may be the day that I actually don't stop on the 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, or 14th article. I'm told there might even be Las Vegas odds in the future. I'm being sarcastic on if I'll ever actually just run through the headlines. But I think today's the day. Let's do it. Video, Muslim scholar celebrates extinction of blue-eyed, blonde-haired Germans. This is on Infowars.com with a bunch of other government people agreeing and sharing that it's very, very wonderful and a good thing to do. 80% of Brits would be happy to quit the UK for Russia after Putin offers free land. That's what the United States used to be, but now it's all locked up and trying to take more land and send in special forces troops to kill you if you go protest. Actually use regular army troops to kill you deader than a hammer. Out in good old Oregon, Italy set to double baby bonus to fight birth rate apocalypse. This all ties together. These three articles tie together. I'll get to those first once I've gone through the headlines. I think this is the day I'm actually going to go through at least 100 articles. Hillary Clinton vows a new gun grab in secret recording, which we have. It's up on Infowars.com. We're going to be playing that for you here today. Secret gun grab. Soros Management Fund, CNBC reports, outlines new allocations, goes bullish on gold. Yes, I personally myself have seen the elite artificially suppress gold for a while. I've been saying for about 6 months I thought it would go up. It's up like 200 and something bucks. I believe that will continue for a while. They can suppress it maybe again, but long term, folks, paper is a fraud. Let's go ahead and go to the next article. Formal Googlers launch a new startup to make trucks driverless. Oh, how wonderful. Hillary Clinton keeps losing, so how come she's winning? LA Times asked the obvious question. They go through a whole debate here that if the delegates don't buy her act, that they're supposed to go with her, even though they belong to Sanders, he will be the nominee. I don't like Sanders, but I'm telling you, he's less establishment than Hillary. I would prefer him over Hillary, quite frankly. But at the same time, it just illustrates how the system is completely and totally a fraud. But Trump was smart and got up and pointed out that it was a fraud. With the Republicans doing it, they played a con game, a confidence game, acted like it was totally normal, and then it blew up in their face. They had to back off, at least for now. But they're trying to develop a third-party run, they admit, to scuttle the Republican Party and ensure Hitlery gets in power. Another report, no-go areas, huge increase in attacks on police in Sweden. Now mainstream news is having to admit giant no-go areas all over Europe. Our reporters have experienced it. We've shown videos from the UK to Germany to Sweden to France. When they have national parade days just with flags, the radical jihadis on welfare, totally spoiled, arrogant, just run out and attack everyone. The police stand down and worship the foreigners attacking because they're setting all this up for the total fall. Globalists are in control of our countries and are bringing us down systematically right now. Oh, more long lines, this time at Atlanta for multiple hours, WBS-TV reports. Just training everybody that the TSA needs more funding. It's how you hold folks hostage. Good job. Good job, federal government, hijacking our transportation. Murder rates in Chicago, L.A., Dallas, and Vegas skyrocket because the economy is imploding. These are all in big city areas where the general population is not armed, of course. Chicago had the highest crime rate in the world 2 years ago. It's doubled since then to double its previous record. These are places run by the mafia, run by the Clintons and the Obamas and others. Hillary Clinton says her husband will fix the economy. That's right. Bill Clinton planted the seeds of economic destruction. We're going to be talking about the real economic record of these people. Princeton professor, there are few superstitions that are more absurd than transgenderism, saying that is basically complete mental illness. 12 signs that a cloud of insanity has descended on the land. I want to go through these 12 signs because it's a good article by Michael Snyder, but I want to just point out there's stuff a lot crazier than this, so I've got a list of about 100. I'm really going to attempt to go through this today. Study, go to church, live longer, CBS Philly. Another scientific study shows what all the other studies show. Absolutely increases your lifespan. Just like the Bible says, follow the Lord thy God's commandments, and you will be given at least 75 years and maybe another 25 on top of it. Go read Leviticus for yourself. Continuing here, I told you at the time this was totally fake because Whole Foods had come out and said it was fake, and the baker that actually made the cake was, quote, gay. I'm not going to use the word you say, not because I dislike you, but because now we can't use the word mother or father either because the media said so. So the baker was homosexual, and he said that the pastor, wanting attention, said that they wrote fag on it. And I could look at the cake and see it was even done in another hand. Whoever had, you know, squeezed out the blue paste, we can probably put it on screen for TV viewers, had put it in a little bit different font. And, I mean, why would someone put in a cake saying love wins and then this comes back? It was a huge publicity stunt, just like most of these things are, a false flag. And guess what? The surveillance camera shows him getting it, and it didn't say it. He went home and did it, and now he's, quote, apologized. But here's a big lesson in all this. Should probably change our headline to homosexual activist caught in false flag or caught staging a hate crime against himself. Because this is all how we're diverted while all our basic liberties are taken. We're diverted off into who bakes people's cakes. While all of our freedoms are stolen, we're signed on to giant debts. But oh my gosh, there's this obsession with bakeries. But here's the big issue. Look at this article out of the Austin American Statesman. Also have one out of KVUE-TV, and they all have the same headline. Pastor to drop lawsuit against Whole Foods over anti-gay slur on cake. It should be pastor caught lying in hoax for attention. Almost every time a swastika gets put on a dorm or a cross is burned in the yard or the lacrosse team supposedly rapes the black woman, 99% of the time it comes out it's fake. I mean, I'm telling you, when is it real? 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 It was real when three white supremacist convicts pulled over and killed a homeless former black convict that they knew and drug him behind their car till his head came off. Then a couple years later, on the same stretch of road, a white homeless person was drugged to death, and there was one article and no coverage. And again, I'm talking about control here, folks, just media control. They will not tell you this guy staged it to the last paragraph and says Whole Foods has video and that they believe he did it himself and that they're suing him. He says, I'm sorry, I shouldn't have done this, but he doesn't admit to it. And the media lets him get away with it. I think it's wrong to drag a red-haired man down the road, a black-haired man down the road, a purple person down the road. The point is, though, it's how the media reports this stuff. Again, there are a lot of problems with the police. Massive corruption in many areas. Part of the corrupt overall system. But statistically, police kill around 1,000 to 1,100 people a year. And in the feds' own investigations, they say around 100 to 150 every year are questionable. Let's say that's a whitewash. Let's say 400 are questionable. No, let's say 500 are questionable. Let's say 550. Half of them are bad shootings, which I don't believe they are. More cops than that get shot a year. But you don't know any of the cops' names that ever got shot, do you? But you know the name of every other person in the inner city that got shot because it's the media hyping it into racial division. And then the feds are coming in to federalize the police to supposedly fix that problem. I'm sorry, the numbers don't add up. Now, do I like cops out there revenue generating instead of stopping criminals? Absolutely not. And that's the government directing the police departments to do that. And so it's like I'm mad at the TSA for the stuff they do, but the Congress does it and the parties do it while they leave the border open and ship in the illegals saying I've got to have my genitals groped. The problem is Congress and the problem is our states not stopping it. But when Texas passed a law, passed it in the House and was about to pass the Senate unanimously in the House to not let them grope children at the airport, Obama 5 years ago threatened air blockades with F-16s. It was almost civil war again. See, think about that. See, all of our rights are being destroyed by multinationals that have come in and taken this country over, just like they did China 200 years ago, or African countries, or you name it. We're being colonized by multinational corporations who want us poor and want to drive down wages and don't want prosperity, who are cold-blooded. They're not free marketers. They're monopoly men. They're our mortal enemies. They exempt themselves from the taxes and regulations they put on us. And we're too busy for 2 years hearing that the lacrosse team raped a black stripper and it turned out the whole thing was fake because she wanted attention. And you know what? People do that because they know they'll get attention. They'll get attention and they'll get lawsuits and people get money because the media plays along with this to divide and conquer our nation and tens of millions of lawyers suing everyone for everything as the economy collapses. You can't do business in this country anymore. Swimming pools are now 2 feet deep because of lawsuits. Diving boards were gone 20 years ago. Dodgeball and tag's been banned. Soon it'll be football and baseball. We're being totally captured in a scientific, panopticonic nanny state designed to kill normal human activity. And the metrics are all in. We're dumb. We're fat. We're stupid. We're lazy. We're jellyfish. Half the public walks around with giant fluoride goiters hanging by their necks. You're under chemical attack. Wake up to it. The problem is not 150 bad shootings a year. You could execute that 150 cops every year. It wouldn't do jack crap. And I'm certainly not here saying I've got no problems with the police. The point is it's a red herring. Excuse me, I'm going to try to control myself. Okay, I got through like 20-something stories. I got like 100 more. When we come back, I'm going through each one, bam, 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 then I'm going back into them. He got demonized by Glenn Beck. He got demonized by Ted Cruz. I got demonized as well by those same individuals. Matt Drudge got attacked by the entire Republican establishment that he was a horrible person, that he was evil, that he was bad, because he pointed out that in the primaries, Trump was winning, but they would then take the delegates in six different states and give them to Cruz and make him win. And just say, oh, it's our rules, we say so. Then they started just canceling the primaries and just having the superdelegates unanimously give everything to Ted Cruz. And folks really got upset. And every day that that happened, Drudge would link to it. Show at InfoWars.com. And just run the headline, she keeps losing. How come she's winning? And that's an LA Times article. And that's what Drudge would link to. He would link to the Denver Post, Associated Press, InfoWars.com, where we had headlines with our reporters on the ground saying they just canceled the election. It was common sense. It was wrong. They tried to say we were wrong, we were kooks, and they failed. And now Hillary is back in the news, and they've got the head of the Federal Elections Commission talking bad about Drudge, saying she's intimidated and got death threats because Drudge linked to an article about her saying that she'd like to shut the Drudge Report down. Oh, the Daily Beast, the poor baby. He links to articles where they admit they're stealing the election from Bernie Sanders. It's a fact. How could you not link to that? He linked to articles, and so did InfoWars, that said that Ted Cruz was having elections canceled and getting all the delegates. They try to act like we're freaks for common sense, but we're not. So that's coming up in the next segment. And all Drudge does is show Fox News holding up a Drudge printout that says she keeps losing. How come she is winning? And then, of course, Drudge mirrors the image again. And all Drudge is doing is saying the sky's blue, trees are green, grass is green, daisies are yellow, dogs bark, cats meow, 2 + 2 = 4. And they just sit there going, you people are nuts. And so Drudge is being demonized yet again. So are we. It's in the news. We're being attacked for criticizing the fact that they're taking Bernie Sanders' delegates. People believe they're going to vote for Bernie Sanders, and then it's just given to Hillary. And then they want to go, look at the radicals that are against it, Matt Drudge and Alex Jones and others. And they've got articles. I've got 4 different articles in my stack today with the Democratic Party going, we're afraid Sanders supporters are going to be violent. They're bad, evil people. See, they changed the subject. When Trump's saying, you're stealing the election, they go, your people are violent. And Ted Cruz came out and jumped the shark and said, oh, yeah, the media's right. Donald Trump is violent. His people are violent, and that's why we're seeing these problems, and he's a racist. All of it made up, and people rejected it. So that's the really exciting news here is folks are rejecting this across the board, and we're having that moment of sanity. And then look right up above it. FEC vice chair claims threats after she tried to regulate Drudge. Oh, she's got to get rid of free speech because she could take Drudge down. Or regulate it. She can do it to anybody, see? A lot of idiots go, good, let them get Drudge. I'm jealous. Oh, boy, you're really stupid. They're going to get you next, dum-dum. Like, a lot of talk radio folks are like, I hope Rush Limbaugh, you know, had a heart attack in Hawaii a few years ago. I hope he dies, or I hope he goes out of business, or I hope they can boycott him. Oh, you're going to be next, moron. They could take anybody's speech, including Michael Moore's. None of us are safe. I don't like Michael Moore, but I'll defend his free speech all day long, big time. Because if you don't hang together, you hang separate. Oh, but the left loved Dinesh D'Souza getting arrested. They absolutely loved it. And they loved the persecution of conservative governors and attorney generals and all the arrests and all the harassment. It's fun. It's powerful to them. They're part of something big, even as their unemployment skyrockets and as Obamacare screws them over. They don't care. They want to feel like they're on the winning team, even if they're losers and fools. Homeland Security has been alerted, it goes on, to the evil of Drudge. And Obama invites Revelle to the White House. And don't worry, Facebook's meeting with trusted Republican insiders, with Republican leaders like Bush's former spokesperson, Perino, and Glenn Beck. But no one else. Now Trump complains one of his representatives will be there. Going to Facebook saying, please don't censor us. Please be nice to us. The fake conservatives are all lining up for the epic battle against the Republic with the forces of Mordor, represented by the Federal Elections Commission, Obama, Hillary, and all the rest of them, as they openly try to steal elections, openly try to shut down the media, openly try to destroy the basic right of the First Amendment. Now, I'm going to hit a bunch of other headlines and then plow back into this and get into a bunch of clips straight ahead, Infowars.com. All right, I want to play a bunch of different election clips. I want to get back into the Federal Elections Commission. A bunch of their members, including the co-chairwoman, coming out and saying that they want to regulate the internet. They want to regulate political speech and basically put election rules on it so they can arrest you and call it money. If I say I don't want them to restrict guns, I don't want them to have an assault weapons ban, and I'm on a couple hundred radio stations, they want to say that's political speech. It's called my right of the First Amendment. But see, they've got all their media, but no one watches it or listens to it. People just laugh at it. It has a 6% trust rate, according to the Associated Press. And so they are dead in the water with us totally kicking their butts. And so they're just running around whining about Drudge Report and InfoWars and other sites. But mainly Drudge Report, because that's the biggest one. That's the archetype. It's like when you use a search engine, you say Google it. The name of a search engine is now Google. The name of the free internet's called Drudge. I mean, it's really becoming that, where if something's just nationalistic, free market, wide spectrum, shows you all the news, lets you make the decision, but has a bent towards freedom, a bias towards the truth, you call it Drudge. Just populist conservatism, libertarianism, whatever you want to call it. Americana. You know, Drudge will link to an article with horror admitting that there are thousands of chimera, part human, part animal creatures, living on farms across the U.S. And the media will even make fun of Drudge if, you know, he links to MIT admitting it, because they didn't want that looked at. That was meant for academics to look at and to get ready for it, not for the public yet. Kind of like it was public and partially declassified 20 years ago that the NSA was spying via keywords and had giant spying hubs in every major telecommunications facility and was putting in even bigger control grids. And by federal law in 1996, all cell phones by 2000 had to have satellite GPS tracker systems and be able to be dialed into even when they're off and turn the microphone on. That's in the congressional record. That's law. That's why I put out films 19, 20 years ago that say exactly what's being admitted today, because it was on paper in law. You don't just think you get all the cell phone makers ubiquitously worldwide to make cell phone spying devices by accident, where all cars now made worldwide for at least a decade have satellite tracker taxing boxes that you pay for in the cost of the car, upwards of $1,000 a piece. You pay for it too, ready to flip them on and start taxing you. And it's starting in Oregon. It's starting in the UK. It's starting in Germany. It's starting in Japan. Worldwide, wired in to tax you. Oh, these boxes accidentally fell in all the cars. We're going to flip a switch and start taxing. That's how dumb they think you are. And the FEC runs around for 2 years putting out press releases saying, we want to regulate Drudge, we want to regulate talk radio, we want to regulate political speech, we are going to outlaw it. We're going to call it political and not let you do it unless it's approved by the FEC, and then you got to pay for your speech to the political class. Like, are you kidding, you monster woman? And then people get upset by you wanting to butcher the First Amendment, and you claim you got some death threats as if her own agency wouldn't do it and hasn't been caught doing it, just like I told you the guy putting fag on the cake in Austin, the preacher, to get attention, the, quote, gay preacher. I said, that's totally fake. Turned out the baker was gay. Turned out the whole, they had video of it saying, you know, what it originally said, and he now basically admits he did it and says he's sorry. Because Whole Foods is suing him. These people, they didn't even go in and target some conservative mom and pop that didn't have a surveillance camera. They'll be smarter next time, don't worry. They went and they targeted the big, ultra-liberal, you know, palace of gayness, basically. You see, these folks aren't even nice to their own people. Because it's all about the new economy is being a victim and suing someone. So he sued them, they sued back, he got caught. How dumb was he, not knowing they got HD cameras all over that thing, over every checkout line? That's how dumb these people are. But you know who's dumber? The good American people of every race, color, creed, nationality, who put up with this, that put up with being conquered by a bunch of snot-nosed college students running around beating people up if they don't approve of your political message. And all over the country, the cops sit there at the universities because they're leftist political officers, commissars, and they agree on video that, yeah, we're going to shut your speech down. No, these people are allowed to attack you. And everybody's like nodding to the weirdo cops, the weird, you know, trendy cops. I mean, this is 1 millimeter from brown shirt stuff. They love it, though. Because if you're a dumbed-down person, all you've got's this fake identity. And all you've got's running around stirring up trouble. I want to go through some more of the headlines. I want to go back into these clips that I've been mentioning. And then I want to go over these key stories. No-go areas, huge increase in attacks on police in Sweden. Video, Muslim scholar celebrates extinction of blue-eyed, blonde-haired Germans and is celebrated in the public forums by Germans who agree they need to die. The Green Party has said it's wonderful as well. We have all the clips. We have a compilation clip as well. We have guys literally going, we are coming for your women, weak Europeans. You will serve us as slaves. You women will wear the hijab. And the Germans are like, yes, in the crowd. I mean, you talk about sick. 80% of Brits would be happy to quit the UK for Russia after Putin offers free land. That's what the United States used to do. Back when we were free, back when we at least had a free market. Italy set to double baby boom to fight birth rate apocalypse. We have a picture of a morbid country. You bet you do. Liberal, trendy, and dying. And then replaced by the most backward, poor, Stone Age, third world countries where all people do is murder and kill each other all day and women are chained up inside slave pits with hoods over their heads. And then George Clooney comes on and says, how dare Trump hate women and Muslims? Oh, yes. Same guy that wants your Second Amendment, but he has bodyguards. The hypocrites of the planet. But let's continue first with the headlines I haven't gotten to. There's only probably 100 more. House to waste $622 million in new Zika virus funding when it's our own government helping cook it up and weaponize it. We've done special reports on that. Socialism's dismal harvest, Venezuelan edition, as the country descends into total hell, but U.S. colleges and people like Sean Penn teach that it's the heaven on earth, a utopia. Defense bill coming this week, a boost for war and tyranny. British students demand LGBT-only accommodation. See, that's what this means, total balkanization, where all the, quote, immigrant groups, minority groups, religious groups, sexual groups want their own little areas now, and you're going to pay for it. Self-segregating. The ultimate balkanization in the name of diversity and unity. Panama Papers reveal George Soros' deep money ties to secretive weapons intel investment firm. NDAA 2017 military-industrial complex wins, people lose. Ron Paul breaks that down. Video on Infowars.com. We got a bunch of other economic news I want to be getting to. But let's get into some of the political stacks that are really, really, really important here in a moment, what's happening with that in these video and audio clips. But first, I'm just going to straight shoot you right now. I've talked to so many people on the ground. You've heard them call in. You've read the rave reviews at third-party sites that are linked at InfoWarsStore.com, where people have had their lives changed by Survival Shield Nation iodine, the purest form of iodine that you can actually absorb. The good halogen that's in there blocking the bad halogens, the chloride, the bromide, the bromine, the fluoride, all of it. That is such a game changer in and of itself. It's incredible. What things like Oxy Powder does, things like DNA Force, things like Lung Cleanse, things like Super Male Vitality that's unfortunately sold out, or Anthroplex that's excellent as well. We still have that special 15% off running for only one more day. So these are things you absolutely owe yourself, and the reason it's a total win is you're funding this broadcast, and your funding is essential for the reporters, the crew, the researchers, and what we do here. And when it comes to the products we have, they're the best out there. We've done the research. We've gone to the top labs, the top companies, and had them produce original, private-labeled products for us that are amazing. Some of our products, like Child Ease and others, are 25-year-old nationwide best-selling products, private-labeled for us at a lower price than the original folks sell it. And it's just incredible. Your kids should take it every day. It doesn't really calm them down, other than the fact that it's got so many concentrated herbs in it that they just work so much better and are so much smarter, in my experience. $19.95, a huge bottle. Give them a teaspoon every day. It's great for adults as well. Sign up for AutoShip, get 10% off. Orders of $50 or more, free shipping as well. InfoWarsLife.com takes you right to the subsection of the nutraceuticals. 4-ounce bottle. Give them a little teaspoon every day. Simply amazing. Child Ease. I mean, there's so many products. We've got the knockout that is 9 different compounds like melatonin, L-tryptophan, valerian root that are all the regular dose you'd buy in the same size caplets from leading competitors for the same price. So they just put filler in. We don't have any filler. It's 9 different known things naturally to give you deep, restful sleep. People are just crazy about this. It's $19.95. A bottle of melatonin of the same dose on average is the same price. See, I don't believe in a system where you sit there and you just have a bunch of marketing, and then you have something even more expensive because there's this perceived value, and then folks pay more for crud because of the advertising and the hype. I just want to give you something at a very low price that is better than anything else out there on the market. Now, I'm a big guy. I take 2 to really sleep like the dead. 1, if I've had too much coffee or whatever, will help. And you can talk to a doctor if you want to give it to your children. It's generally seen as safe, but before you breathe air into your lungs, talk to your doctor. Before you walk, talk to your doctor. Before you eat, tomatoes, talk to your doctor. I just want to just say that for everybody, you know, talk to your doctor before you take any of these products, because they're all, you know, what you call FDA grass is seen as the, you know, safe vitamins and minerals. But in this world today, it's important to always talk to your doctor, because if they tell you oxygen's bad, you should put a bag over your head and tie it up and die, because that's what they said. Okay, I'm being sarcastic. The truth is, just do your own research, talk to your doctor, check it out, InfoWarsLife.com. And separately, Vitamin Mineral Fusion came in a few months ago, sold out in a week and a half, sold out for over a month and a half. It is all the key minerals, all the key vitamins, the key amino acids for upload of it, and it is just incredible. Go check it out, read the label for yourself. It's concentrated. It's amazing. InfoWarsLife.com. Your purchase funds the operation and makes everything we do here absolutely possible. We also have a really high quality spectrum of storable foods from My Patriot Supply and our private labeled InfoWars Select. Specials are over, but they're already discounted regardless. So check that out. With all the things that are happening, we need to be self-sufficient. The summer's coming, the fall's coming. We have the best selection of really high quality, lowest price you're going to find, big, probably the biggest selection out there of non-GMO, heirloom, open pollinated seeds from fruit trees down to potatoes to tobacco. You name it, we've got it. The full spectrum, InfoWarsStore.com. So get prepared and fund the tip of the spear in the InfoWar. This is really the total win-win, because you're funding the fight against the globalist, the information war, the true voice of America. That's really what we are. The true voice of Renaissance, the true voice of freedom, and this platform that is just having huge inroads across the board, probably second only to something like Drudge Report. And with all of that, you are then getting the products you need to be prepared and to have a good, healthy life. It's amazing. That's what I've set out to do in everything I'm engaged in, because I'm a symbiotic person. I'm a win-win person down to my core, and I want to thank you all for your support, but also your prayers, and also the fact that you defend us out there from the enemy and that you spread the word about the broadcast. I want to salute you. All right. I want to get into the election. Let me go over a few of these headlines. I'm going to start playing some of these amazing clips. Nancy Pelosi, I guarantee Trump will not be president. California Democrat says New York billionaire, a here today, gone tomorrow candidate. Total arrogance. We've been hearing that for over a year. Former Trump girlfriend hits back at upsetting New York Times cover story that misquoted her, saying that once he said she was fat. I mean, that's all they got on him? My goodness. Majority of Republican voters trust Trump over Ryan to lead party. NBC News. Of course they do. Flashback. Bill Clinton talks like Trump on immigration. We are a nation of laws. We're going to play that clip. Hillary Clinton keeps losing, so why, or so how come she's winning? LA Times asked the question, it's okay. Drudge asked it, he's evil. The Federal Election Commission says this is electioneering, they want to shut him down right now. And then go, we've gotten death threats, implying he did it. I hear this all the time on MSNBC, CNN, they go, Alex Jones's fans have been known to threaten people. Oh, like the anti-Trump folks beating everybody up? Trying to run cars over people? It's just crazy. We're all known to be nonviolent, but they imply we're violent. A small group of superdelegates could close the deal for Hillary. Bloomberg. Oh, just selling out an idea for folks. And remember, it's the New York Times and all these other publications calling for the assassination of Trump, and that's okay. And all these people online, there's still a Facebook calling for the assassination of Trump. Now, one guy got on there and said he's going to kill his family, so the Secret Service did go arrest him. Good. You got free speech, but you don't get to call for death. Nevada Democrats warn of DNC of violence from Sanders supporters. You see, oh, roll call. Oh, you know, they took the state in Nevada from him when he won it, so now they're complaining about the delegates going to Hillary, so they're planning to protest, and that's called violence, see? Not being robbed, defending yourself, if you're being mugged, is violence. Upheaval in Nevada raises concerns over Democrat unity. Then it gets more disgusting, and we know why Bernie isn't talking more about the steal. Bernie's the early favorite for Hillary's running mate. Well, that's the worst possible combination. That dumb communist loon with that evil demon. All you Bernie supporters out there, so many of you are listeners, I've learned, because you just don't like the establishment. He's not going to tax the rich people. He's going to tax the middle class and give it to Warren Buffett in banker bailouts. Okay, just get ready. You want to live like Venezuela? Want to live like a slave? Get ready. I mean... Woodward envisions the Washington Post, Bill and Hillary's Chelsea on Mount Rushmore. Boy, it's getting sicker by the minute. And then The Hill has a story, Hillary's unlikely ally, the media. Oh, it's so unlikely that they'd be the ally. We come back, I'm going to hit that, and then I'm going to get into the stories. I'm actually play them. Nancy Pelosi says Trump will not be president because she's Lord and Savior, I guess, and knows everything. We've got Hillary Clinton vows a new gun grab. I want to play that first. It's audio recorded stealthily in a meeting. Bill Clinton is talking like Trump on immigration. We're going to get to that clip. Gingrich, it's not Bill Clinton's job to run economy. We've got Hillary on Donald Trump has scary, dangerous talk of loose cannon. It's the one that starts all these wars. And I like to talk about not having war against Syria to put Al-Qaeda in and not attacking Russia. And I like to talk about being nice, but if you mess with us, we then defend ourselves. That's an honorable, soft power way to be. Not a sniveling thug like Hillary. There is life after death. Scientists reveal shock findings from groundbreaking study. And there's a bunch of other studies that back this up as well. They can actually pick up and read the consciousness. And then at some point it leaves. Energy actually goes. Pretty powerful. We're going to be breaking that down. We're also going to be getting into, that's out of the Express News. We're going to be getting into magic mushrooms lift severe depression in trial. That's been known forever by, well, the Romans and some of their apothecary. The Vikings took them whenever they would go into battle. But they're well known to, in a lot of people, just in depression, sometimes for years. Kind of a chemical reset in the brain. Going to church could help you live longer. Study finds CBS News. I'm going to get to that as well. Startup wants to put self-driving big rigs on highways. The rise of the robots. We better stand up for humans. This isn't innovation, folks. This rollout of automation is to make us obsolete, the globalists admit. That's why we've got to block it and start a movement where there's little human signs on things saying this was made by humans, farmed by humans, touched by human hands. Humans were given work in this. Because they're not just going to let us, the globalists have said this in their white papers. Bill Joyce wrote about it and why the future doesn't need us. The decision was made more than 20 years ago not to build a world where we just entertain ourselves in oil paint all day. They're setting up robots and computers to take us out of the equation to then exterminate most of us, and so we can't resist. We'll first be made totally domesticated, though. It's really incredible. I told you 20 years ago they'd still have cash, but it would just be digitally marked. Now they've announced that openly. I know the enemy. I don't just research their own documents. I know the enemy. I connected the dots, folks. I know what I'm talking about, okay? Please listen to me. Please listen to me. These are horrible people that fly around on giant jets filled with kidnapped children, taking them to rape camps. They hate you. And because you're not like them, you just can't imagine they're like that. They're more evil than I can imagine or you can imagine. Let's start playing clips, and I'll give the number out, and we'll take calls next hour, 800-259-9231. First-time callers in the first hour. I take calls next hour, 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. Here's a short clip of Hillary in a secret speech to her minions, her ringwraiths, that she will get those guns. Here it is.
So I'm going to speak out. I'm going to do everything I can to rally people against this pernicious, corrupting influence of the NRA. And we're going to do whatever we can. I was proud when my husband took them out, and we were able to ban assault weapons, but he had to put a sunset on. So 10 years later, of course, you know, Bush wouldn't agree to reinstate them. We've got to go after
it. Pause.
And here
it pause. Back it up 5 seconds. Bush pushed the assault weapons ban. The Republican leadership tried to pass it. You're so such an evil liar. And you've got bodyguards, and you have a will to dominate your slaves, and you hate it. We're not completely your slaves yet, even though you bankrupted us by design, you wicked monster that kept more than half the money from the Haitian children. You demonic pig that takes money from these blob sheiks that have women as slaves. You are the worst person on earth. Probably. Let's go back. I'm not sure. Maybe Soros may be worse. Two peas in a pod. Let's finish up the clip.
Of course, you know, Bush wouldn't agree to reinstate them. We've got to go after this. And here again, the Supreme Court is wrong on the Second Amendment. And I am going to make that case every chance I get. So I will need your help on that.
That's right. She's gonna stack the Supreme Court. And, you know, if people need to die in secret rituals and no autopsy, it's going to happen. Uh-huh. No autopsy, just first announcement. No autopsy, nothing happened. Different stories. We'll change the stories. We'll be right back. Stay with us. Second hour, straight ahead. Thank you for joining us. We are going to be going to your phone calls coming up in the next segment. 800-259-9231 is the toll-free number to join us. The big story up on Infowars.com is the same big story up on DrudgeReport.com. She keeps losing. How come she is winning? Superdelegates are rebelling, saying, look, Hillary, it's okay for the popular vote to count. That's what's supposed to happen. And you shouldn't be getting the delegates when you're losing these states. And the media shouldn't keep calling you the winner. So the same thing that happened with Cruz trying to steal things from Trump is they tried to give us that idea that that was okay, but the public didn't buy it. And so now they've gotten to the point where they're demonizing Drudge, and they're having the head of the security, the Federal Election Commission, come out and say that she got threats after she tried to regulate Drudge. That's a quote. So first, they didn't want to regulate the internet. They didn't want to regulate free speech. They didn't want to regulate the written word. They didn't want to regulate books and publications and newspapers. But now they do. Now they do. This is how horrible these people are. And are you surprised that out of billions of people on the internet worldwide, she probably got some legitimate threats? You're a public figure trying to get rid of free speech, lady. The British tried that with the colonies, and there was a war over it. They also tried to take the guns. It was called 1776. When there's 4th of July, and you're sitting out in your big mansion or whatever with all the looted, you know, money from all your insider buddies, that's what the hot dogs and hamburgers and explosions are, is simulations of Fort Sumter and other forts under attack. That's what the Star-Spangled Banner is about. Oh, so can you see? As I butcher that. Oh, say can you see? In fact, can somebody bring me the Star Spangled Banner so I can? I got it pretty much memorized, but I'll bungle or bumble some of it. Maybe we should just get some beautiful rendition of the Star Spangled Banner, and then play that for her so she understands what the bombs bursting in air means. But still, through the night, our flag was still there, being bombarded by the British fleet. Oh, so can you see the Star Spangled Banner? Do you understand that, lady? I mean, you come to take everything we've got. You tell us we have no free speech. We're bitter clingers. We can't have our Bible. We can't have our guns. All we can do is deliver our five-year-olds to you to learn how their boys to learn dresses, and if they're girls, to put on boys' outfits. And how to get Janet Reno haircuts, or how to, you know, the new Ken dolls look like Rachel Maddow. And the boy dolls, I mean, I guess they're going to look like Mary Poppins. I mean, we're just little Legos here for you to arrange however you want. We have no destiny. We have no consciousness. You're just obsessed with planet tranny. And people that aren't even hating you. I don't think about such. I don't care. You're just constantly hopping around, you know, declaring our children belong to you, foaming at the mouth. And then Drudge wants to link to Hillary speeches, you know, where she's saying she's going to get our guns, and you don't want that political speech. You say it's political that she wants our guns and that we don't want to be disarmed, so we can't show people what she said. It's just like separation of church and state. That's in a letter from Thomas Jefferson about not having a state-run religion, which I totally agree with Jefferson. Then they misrepresent it to Christians and say Jefferson wants to ban your churches and your free speech. No, Congress shall make no law. He helped write the Bill of Rights. Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof. That's the first half of the First Amendment. Then of the press and the people to assemble and all the rest of it. Okay? So they have no jurisdiction. And they have no jurisdiction over my speech. They can claim political money to a candidate has some type of regulation. But see, now that's down to my speech writing an article saying Hillary Clinton is a demonic mobster pig and an enemy of this country bought off by the Gulf states supporting the suppression of women worldwide. Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Central, we're live. We're into the second hour. Thank you for joining us. Wide open phones, 800-259-9231. Well, we covered probably 80 stories last hour. I did a pretty good job, I think, overall. Played a lot of clips. I'm going to play more clips and analyze them right now, then go right to your phone calls and then more news. After I take a couple rounds of calls, I'm going to actually get to these videos. Video on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com right now. A Paul Joseph Watson article. Muslim scholar celebrates extinction of blue-eyed, blonde-haired Germans. So we have a video of the Green Party and other Muslim leaders getting up saying, yay, get rid of the white people. This is wonderful. I mean, this is the biggest line of racism I've ever heard, and it just shows what leftist brainwashing does to people. And I'll be honest, I've always been an inclusive, very open person, but when folks are running around saying this openly, it gets old. And a lot of folks that, quote, aren't white, but also a lot of them are white, they just are so out of their minds, they think it's normal to say whites are inherently bad. So that's coming up. 80% of Brits would be happy to quit Russia. 80% of Brits would be happy to quit UK for Russia after Putin offers free land. That's a real story. We're going to get to that. Italy set the double baby bonus to fight birth rate apocalypse. No-go areas. Huge increase in attacks on police in Sweden by the wonderful radical jihadis that have been brought in mass. But before I do that, and go to your phone calls, I want to play a couple of these clips here. I already played Hillary saying, don't worry, I'm going to get your guns. And I'm going to stack the Supreme Court when I win. And we're going to take the guns and promising to do so. Let's play a clip of Nancy Pelosi, another mob boss. I mean, she is mafia, folks. Look into her. And went to Congress with no money, worth hundreds of millions now. I mean, just a monstrous creature. And she says, I guarantee Trump will not be president here today, gone tomorrow. That's the same thing the actor, George Clooney, says, because he hates women, because he doesn't want to bring Muslims in. I mean, just upside down world. Let's go ahead and play Nancy Don Carleone Pelosi.
You know what? He's not going to be president. Donald Trump is not going to be president of the United States. take it to the bank.
Okay.
I guarantee it.
All right. All right.
And hopefully, and I'm certain it will happen when we have our nominee, mm-hmm. whoever she may be.
Right.
She will take this debate to a higher plane. Mm-hmm. And nobody, you would never stoop to his
higher plane.
That's not who we are. When people complain about Donald Trump talking about Mexicans, talking about Muslims, talking about women and all the rest, that's what we hear every day in the Congress. Mm-hmm. And not in private. In committee, on the floor, in press conferences. Mm-hmm. If you put side by side what some of our members have said, important members, chairs of committees and the mm-hmm. rest, he's a here today, gone tomorrow, candidate for president.
Oh, that's
they
enough.
Have had.
I mean, if we had 40 million Americans in Mexico waving American flags, the Mexicans would flip out. Even if it was Americans bringing money and jobs. But we're getting mainly poor people in. We're collapsing. We're going bankrupt. The multinationals are doing this. It's not racist to say we can't have 10,000 women coming in every week from China to have their babies for free. And then even, quote, wealthy Chinese come here. Because why shouldn't you have a $30,000, $40,000 birth here for free? Even rich people come here because we're such a joke. Because the globalists know taxpayers are paying for it all, and they're collapsing us by design. And then she sits there and turns it into, we're going to a higher plane. Like the Lolita Express with the convicted pedophile with Clinton flying around with the little kids? I mean, up at 33,000 feet where nobody can save them? At 30,000 feet, no one can hear you scream. And on Pedo Island, no one can hear you scream when that weird, undead zombie Bill Clinton walks into the bedroom. We got to get weaponized against these people. We can't back down. We got to go all the way against these enemies of the Republic. Let's go ahead now and go to another clip. Here's Bill Clinton talking like Donald Trump on immigration in 1996.
One of these areas is the problem of illegal immigration.
We have to stop the inflow of illegals coming into our country.
This administration has taken a strong stand to stiffen the protection of our borders.
We will build a wall. It will do what it's supposed to do. Keep illegal immigrants out.
We are increasing border controls by 50%.
We're going to have a border. It's going to be a real border.
We have a country. We have to have borders.
We are increasing inspections to prevent the hiring of illegal immigrants. And tonight I announce I will sign an executive order to deny federal contracts to businesses that hire illegal immigrants.
What are we going to do about illegal hiring?
You can be very, very strong. It could be a huge financial penalty. It could be beyond a
what
financial
penalty. What are these guys
penalty.
In your... Because that's the magnet.
That with E-Verify and with
various
methods.
Oh, are you for it?
I'm for it.
We should honor every legal immigrant here working hard to be a good citizen, but we are also a nation of laws.
We have a country. We have to have laws. We either have a country or we don't.
Now, you can just type in Mexico, the worst on immigrants, Mexico, the hardest on illegals, 6 months to 1 year hard labor. If you've got credit cards and ID, they call your family in Guatemala or wherever and try to shake money out of you. And then they also will torture the illegals or even Mexican citizens to find out if they're hiding illegals or if they're illegals to shake money out of them. And that's what Mexico does to its own people. It does it to tourists that go out of the tourist zones. I mean, warning to Americans, folks. If you're going to Mexico, there's four or five cities you can go to now and a few other zones, but you better not go into the other areas because you'll be shaken down. And that's a fact. Like, don't go to North Korea. It's dangerous. And Mexico is degenerating. And I don't take pleasure in that. Believe me, if there was a safer country around here, I'd be getting out of here. I mean, this country, I don't think you can fix it at some levels. Those of us that don't want to be slaves should start saying no to the system. And try to create communities based on freedom. And I guess migrate to states that are not going to go along with this. But we are in the hands of really, really evil people, folks. Now let's go ahead and go to another clip that I want to break down here. And that's dealing with what's happening with Joy Behar. I've been on her show before, both The View and on her CNN show. It's a pretty nice lady behind the scenes. Don't blame Hillary for Bill. Unless you blame Melina for Trump's sexual harassment. That is such a horrible statement. Melina has only been married to him, what is it, or Melania for, I don't know, 10 years or whatever. I can't pronounce any names, including my own. Sorry, folks. No teleprompter. And Hillary was there politically going after these women and saying they were liars actively. And Clinton settled rape cases and got caught engaged in perjury. We're talking about Trump asking women out when he wasn't married and Trump telling an old girlfriend 30 years ago in the 80s she was overweight. And now that's been recanted by the girlfriend. So it's apples and oranges. Yes, if she was defending Trump years after he settled rape cases and she was political, then you could criticize her. But she hasn't done that yet, and Donald Trump hasn't done anything. So this is how they've scrambled reality. Let's go ahead and play this clip.
Is he guilty of sexual harassment when he yes. accuses Bill Clinton often of sexual harassment?
Okay, that's another thing. You know what? They're going to bring up Bill Clinton. When he gets accused of all of this, he brings up Bill Clinton.
Does.
Okay, Bill Clinton's a dog also. What does that have to do with Hillary Clinton? Well, are we going to ask Melania? Are we going
to
blame Melania for this piece in the Times?
Well, you'd have
okay,
to go,
so don't
maybe.
Go after
you'd
Hillary.
Have to perhaps go
Melania hasn't covered anything up because Donald Trump hasn't done anything. Just because you write a 16-page article about how he would go to cocktail parties and ask good-looking women out or ask them what they like to do for fun. I mean, what man hasn't done that before they were married or after they were married? But see, being normal is freakazoid nowadays. I want to go to your phone calls. We're going to do that when we come back from this break. But first, I want to play the ex who was misquoted as saying that he said she was fat once, and that was just the end of the world. This is Ms. Lane talking about the fact that he was a gentleman on Fox.
I did not have a negative experience with Donald Trump, mm-hmm. and I don't appreciate them making it look like that I was saying that it was a negative experience.
You knew him
not.
Very well, right? You dated him for several months?
That's correct. Yes, and he was never made me feel like I was being demeaned in any way. He never offended me in any way. He was very gracious. I saw him around all types of people, all types of women. He was very kind, thoughtful, generous. He was a gentleman.
Yeah, I know a lot of people that have known Donald Trump, not just Stone, for 30, 40 years, and they just say the guy is so nice, unless you mess with him. That it's just wild. In fact, even the brash guy you see on The Apprentice and stuff was an exaggeration of Trump. And he just treats women so good. So good. But he also doesn't put up with any crap. Zero from women. Zero. Totally nice to him. Best houses, flying around the world, caviar, the best exercise, the best transportation, the best homes, everything. Treated like princesses. But he doesn't put up with any baloney. And so that's supposedly a bad thing. That's supposedly an evil thing. That's supposedly a horrible thing. But I've talked to some people that work for Trump, and they just say, if you're a hard worker, do a good job. He is so loyal. His whole organization is loyal. But the minute you do sideways stuff, you're gone. And the amount of money he gives to charity behind the scenes is reportedly staggering. And everybody's heard about the stories he never talked about deformed kids of staff of his or people that stopped when his limousine was broken down and helped give him a jump. So he paid off their, $400,000 house mortgage. I mean, Trump is a wild man and they don't like him because of the fact that he's for real. As best I can tell, folks, Donald Trump is for real. He wants to be the turnaround expert that helps the American people help him turn this country around. And the reason it's so easy is globalism is designed to make us bankrupt and dependent and controlled. All you do is turn off globalism and our nation state will explode. The United States until 1913 on average had a 10.2% growth rate. They call 3% overheating now. And that's with cooked numbers. So they want us poor. Donald Trump doesn't.
You're the devil in disguise.
Oh, yes, you are. That's what's scary is we know how evil these people are. And then they just invert reality. You can take the speeches of Trump and they're word for word what Clinton and others said, because it's common sense, but the Clintons didn't act on what they did. And that's my biggest concern, is that Trump wouldn't act on what he says he'll do. And I think he's for real. I think that's why they're so scared of him, because they wouldn't be scared of him if he wasn't for real. They'd love it. We're going to find out. I know that. I want to go to your phone calls. And coming up, EU chief calls Boris Johnson's EU Nazi comparison absurd. That's the front runner for the British Prime Ministership right now, former mayor of London. Well, there's a good video up on Infowars.com where David Knightbreak sit down. The Texit, or the Texas exit, Tex exit, 8 reasons for Texas secession. My biggest reason, and I want to keep the republic together, but if our country's totally run by globalists and already gone and under multinational subdivision and receivership, then we've got to just try to keep some part of America alive. And then we just announced Texas is what's left and a few other states and others that want to be somewhat free market, not suicidal, and join us. I mean, you know, that's one way, is to have the states pull out of the federal government because it's illegitimate. And a lot of scholars are saying that now. I mean, we're really under global receivership, in their own words. We've been maneuvered into rack and ruin. The whole world is unraveling into hell. The wealthiest area of Spain voted like 89% to leave 6 months ago. Remember that? In Catalonia. Catalan, beautiful place. I've been there. And the central government said, you can't leave. Well, what do you do when 89% say we're not playing ball anymore? It's game over. I don't care what you say or what you do. You cannot stop the people. And so they're having referendums to just pull out. I mean, what's Spain going to do? Roll tanks in? They don't even have an industry now because of the environmental regulations. The whole country's shutting down. And Catalan doesn't want to do it. They don't want to commit suicide with you. Steve, Manny, John, Cody, and many others are going to you right now. Let's go ahead and talk to Steve in Maryland. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. I just want to get your take on Trump meeting with Kissinger. We know who Kissinger is. And I don't want to look at this from a standpoint that Trump's not doing.
Well, it's okay to criticize Trump about it. Go ahead. I mean, go ahead. Give us your take. It's all right.
I just don't see the benefit in this. And I was hoping to get your take on it because you study this stuff. You understand it. And I'm just trying to get another viewpoint on this.
Well, we've got a story up on Infowars.com with the headline, Oops, Trump's meeting with Kissinger. Kissinger is one of the top globalists in the world. He's kind of fading like David Rockefeller is. Zbigniew Brzezinski's pretty much in charge at many levels, advising the globalists for my research. Jane Baker's still a big kingmaker. And he's met with Richard N. Haass of the Council on Foreign Relations. He's in the top 20. He met last week in Houston at his law firm. Trump did with James Baker, who's still high-powered, and now he's meeting with Kissinger. And it's, Trump to meet with Kissinger for foreign policy advice, Steve Watson. Face-to-face session comes after weeks of phone conversations. If Trump didn't meet with them, they'd come after me with that much hardcore. After he met with Haass, Haass came out and attacked him a week later, and Trump didn't change his rhetoric. He got more nationalistic, more anti-globalist. Trump has not changed his rhetoric after he met last week with James Baker. So I don't care if he meets with these people, but I do care if he changes his rhetoric and then changes his actions. I personally have had Rothkopf, the second command to Kissinger, the head of the Kissinger Group, on when he was the head of the Kissinger Group. He came on the show, and John Harmon heard it during the breaks. I said, you know I'm Alex Jones, right? And he's like, oh, we know who you are, but I thought you want to talk to me and be sold on this. You're a smart guy. You know, you ought to be involved. You ought to come to some of our meetings. And I kept chewing him out for 30 minutes. And at the end of it, he said, I'll never talk to you again. I can't believe you're so stupid, and hung up. So I've been in meetings with CEOs. I've had the globalists invite me to things when I'm already somewhere. A lot of times I'll be in LA or New York or London, and the phone rings here at the office, and they say such and such wants to meet with you in private. And so I've gone and met with some pretty high-powered folks. Usually it's gopher level, right below a Kissinger, right below a Baker. Or, I mean, I've met with presidents and CEOs of media companies, so I've been at the top of those. And, man, they give you a New World Order global government speech, and I tell them, listen, I hear all how it's a great idea, but really it's for centralized control of eugenics. And they'll just say, Alex, you're a smart guy. You really should be with us. But they know I'm a journalist, and if I ever blow confidence in one of these private meetings, I'll never get those type of informations again. So that's why I don't come out and, you know, say the specifics of what went on. But they don't, they hold their cards close to their vest, too. But, I mean, I've had them, just like Mark Dicer's in a meeting with the media head, and he said, look, let's just worship Lucifer together, Mark. I've had them do that with me, too. I mean, these people are freaks, folks. I'm going to come back to you, Steve. Stay there. All right, I'm going right back to your calls. Then I'm getting into the situation in Europe with the radical Muslims demanding full control of everything, running around intimidating everybody, beating people up. shutting down bars, attacking women wearing miniskirts, and the police are defending it, and the leftists and the Green Parties are defending it with pleasure. They want to dominate culture, they want control, and they've got their bully boys. That'll do it. And they mean business. So coming up, top imam, Muslim migrants should breed with Europeans to conquer their countries. That's an article from months ago by Paul Watson. The latest one actually gets into all of this, and it is pretty incredible, where they say we'll get rid of the blonde-haired, blue-eyed people. Muslim scholar celebrates extinction of blue-eyed, blonde-haired Germans. That's coming up in a moment. First off, I'm not going to belabor this, but I'm talking to the listeners that have heard the show and heard me talk about iodine deficiency and heard me talk about the bad halogens, fluoride, chlorine. The list goes on and on. Your glands, like the thyroid, but not just the thyroid, get filled with the bad halogens that they admit cause all sorts of medical problems, cancer, you name it, and fry your hormone endocrine systems. If it's not a chemical weapon, boy, it should be. And they know. Harvard admits fluoride lowers IQ, causes thyroid cancer, bone cancer. Just check it out for yourself. Well, what blocks it? Because your body won't absorb this into your glands if you've got good iodine. Most people have massive iodine deficiencies because even some of the iodine in food is bound to other metals and other chemicals. We have pure iodine. It's like 99999999. Deep earth comes from purple crystals that if you drop one on the ground, like the movie Alien, it burns through the ground like five floors. It doesn't burn chromatic stuff, but it burns everything else. We have video of it in a Petri dish with just normal heat under it. It turns into purple gas. You think I Love Jeannie's about to fly out the top. That's why it's so pure. It doesn't come from the ocean. It's not bound to salt. It's not bound to other heavy metals. It's totally pure, totally clean. And your body just slurps it up right into the cells, and it's changed my life the last 3.5 years I've been taking it. It is very inexpensive. InfoWarsLife.com. Couple drops on the tongue, couple drops in water every day. It is amazing. Consult your physician before you take it. Because if your thyroid's already full of garbage and about to, you know, melt down anyways, you know, I guess hypothetically you could have some issues, you know. Not with this, but because of where you were already at. So consult your physician. It says that on the bottle. But without iodine, you die. Consult your physician before you breathe oxygen as well, just from the air. I'm serious. When before you walk, consult the physician. Before you eat green peas, before you get 1 hour of sunshine, just the nanny state loves you, okay? Just don't buy Survival Shield Nation Iodine X2. No, seriously, it's amazing. InfoWarsLife.com. We have a patented system that Dr. Krupp got from the Russians to do this. It is amazing. The gas is injected live time into a very complex process into organic palm oil. And it's super active. InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. We're doing the sale one more day and it's over. Food sale's over. But one more day on the Anthroplex that is a male enhancement for energy, strength, libido. But I don't know why we put male, because it's just as good for females, Dr. Grimm says. It's got a lot of the herbs that are in Super Male Vitality. They're organic, but they're dry herbs, so it isn't as hard to produce. It isn't as expensive. And Super Male is very affordable, but it's so hard to get all the time. The wet herbs, that it's sold out half the time. So we have a basically dry version that's about half the price, and I think is almost as good. Some people say it's even better. The point is, look out when you take this. Talk to your physician again, because if I take two of these, I'm like a Tyrannosaurus. Well, I'm more than that, to quote Jesse Ventura. What's he saying, Predator? He's chewing tobacco. He says, this stuff will make you a sexual Tyrannosaurus. Well, that's not why I take it, but dramatic effects is what people normally notice in a day or two, and I'm just going to leave it at that. Regardless, you can't lose because you're funding the hardcore broadcast. So, again, ladies and gentlemen, InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, or you can simply call toll-free 888-253-3139. That's 888-253-3139. I want to thank you all for your support. Free shipping on orders of $50 or more, and you get 10% off when you sign up for auto ship. You can cancel anytime. We've got 19 different products now at InfoWarsLife.com. And then, of course, we have over 1,000 products total at InfoWarsStore.com, from Olan Labe t-shirts to Hillary for Prison t-shirts to you name it. By the way, we did a hashtag handcuffs for Hillary. Joe Biggs did, with Leanne McAdoo and Pat Riley, one of our latest additions here at the office, longtime friend of mine. And we sold out of almost every size over the weekend. But good news, we didn't take them down and say that they were backordered, because I don't count it as backordered when the truck is on its way right now from the factory on the East Coast where these are made, right here in America, to Austin. And so it should be here tomorrow. So they are not sold out, just in time. A 4.9 rating on these shirts. Hillary for President on the front, 2016 on the back, in red, Legalize Freedom, Infowars.com. And it's causing a phenomenon of people meeting like-minded people on the street. It's causing a phenomenon at Trump rallies, other liberty-based rallies, where like 1 in 10, 1 in 5 now are wearing the shirts. It's causing a huge phenomenon, and it's helping fund this operation to cover Bilderberg, to cover the RNC, the DNC, to have our reporters in the field around the country every day and around the world. That is expensive, but newsmaking and is giving the people eyes and ears out there. We also have the Make America Free hat triple pack, where you can buy them individually. I don't know if it's a ripoff of Trump, but it's made in America by the same manufacturer. And it says Make America Free Again. And on the back it says Infowars.com with the Molon Labe snake on there. The Don't Tread on Me snakey. So this is a hat I love. Turns a lot of heads. Meet a lot of like-minded people. Infowarsstore.com for that as well. Okay, let's now go right back to the caller. Stephen, if folks just joined us, you called in and said Trump has been talking some to Kissinger on the phone, and now he's going to meet with him in person. If Kissinger comes out and endorses Trump, I will be very troubled by that, because it'll show that they're trying to get close to him. Now, if they think they can't defeat him, they may try to cozy up to be close to him so he trusts them, so they can insert somebody in there like George Herbert Walker Bush with Reagan. But if I see Trump back off his stances, or if I see him not deliver on his promises, then I will turn against Donald Trump. But I think the fact that he's trying to be the president of the U.S., he's got to meet with the foreign policy wonks who've run this country for decades, or they will kill him. And a lot of these gangsters work like that. If you meet with them and at least treat them with respect, they may not kill you right away. But if you don't know that Henry Kissinger is a major dangerous gangster, you're crazy. So quite frankly, if I was Donald Trump, I would meet with Haas. I would meet with Kissinger. I would meet with all of them. And I'd tell them, you've done a lot of really bad things. You've sold out America for this global government. It's not working. Even if you're for it, I believe nationalism's the way to go. And the people are not going to go along with your plan anymore. And so you need to realize that if you just back off, you can keep your wealth. If you don't back off, you're going to end up, you know, getting arrested down the road because you're trying to set up such authoritarian systems. The same message I give the globalists every day here. And I've had the head of the Kissinger group, Rothkopf, the direct minion, the number two, the mini-me, the baby evil of Kissinger, try in front of John Harmon. John, if you're in there, turn your mic on. You're up in Minnesota because you were there when he was on 9 years ago for 45 minutes. You were there during the break. So what did Rothkopf say to me during the breaks?
If I recall correctly, he was just basically trying to recruit you. He said something along the lines like, you aren't going to win this thing and you should just join us. And I mean, it was pretty blatant. And you were just, are you kidding me? Like, is this really happening? So,
and that went on for what, like three breaks? And he said, look, you're part of the super class. You're the top conspiracy guy that, you know, our opposition. You're challenging our worldview. You're challenging our narrative. Same thing that Rove had said about history's actors. And he was just basically saying, you can have your place in this, but you've got to, under the table, join us. And what did he say from memory? Because I know you were listening and you were blown away and you actually came on air and talked about it. And it wasn't off record. He didn't say this is off record. That's why I even said, hey, you know, my board op's listening right now. You're talking to the studio. And he's like, ah, whatever. You're just too dumb to understand that. What else did you hear him say?
I mean, that was pretty much the gist of it. I mean, it happened so long ago. But, yeah, he was trying to recruit you. And it was for real. I couldn't believe it. And, I mean, some of the conversations that happen off the air during the breaks are the most hardcore things on the show. And, yeah, it's supposed to be in confidence or whatever, but it's moments like that I wish we were recording our off-air conversations. But yeah, he was trying to recruit you.
Yeah, Rothkopf couldn't believe that he was like inviting me to come up to New York and inviting me to. I'm just, oh yes, let me immediately join the New World Order. But see, Glenn Beck's going to meet with Zuckerberg. See, He gets the calls. He is on it. And that's why he went on TV two weeks ago and said, I've got the guy that did American Idol and Oreos working for me. I've got establishment with me. Folks don't want the establishment. Not in the end game. I mean, you don't sell out to these people and go anywhere now. This is a bad idea.
And that's what they're betting on, that, you know, you should just sell out because you can't beat them. And it's messed up. Yeah.
Well, I can't sell out to an elite that keeps getting caught on airplanes with little kids. I mean, it'd be one thing if it was Boss Hogg stuff and they were nationalistic and pro-gun and didn't have it out for the family and, you know, there was some other corrupt group trying to take over the government, so I sided with some other group that still did some bad stuff, you know, inside contracts or something. I'm being totally honest. I would try to reform it from within. I don't support stuff like that, but I would not be fighting, risking my life, saying things and doing things that are very dangerous. I wouldn't be going all out every day if this didn't absolutely mean the death of freedom if these people win. I mean, they are so bad, folks, you cannot join with them. So when I sit up here and say I'll never sell out, it is because I'm a good guy and I have moral values. But at the same time, I wouldn't be in an all-out 110% fight if these people weren't pure evil. That's my view. Because a lot of folks say, why don't you just compromise? You can get more done on the inside. No, you can't. No, you can't compromise with these people. They're eugenicist. They're globalist. They have it out for the general public. They're evil. Does that answer your question, Stephen?
Yes, and for me, this kind of ties into the Hillary and the Second Amendment attack. I live in Maryland. In order to buy a handgun, you have to take a class, which is 4 hours. Then you have to wait 30 days to get that HQL in the mail. Then you can go purchase the gun. Then you have to wait 8 days after purchasing that gun in order to come back and pick it up because you need a cool off period. So gun control does not work because, as we all know, Baltimore is right up there with the rest of them. D.C., right up there with the rest of them. And you can't even buy a gun in D.C. So for me, this is just part of the bigger picture. It's a piece of it for me. And I understand where you're coming from. So thanks.
God bless you. I appreciate your call. We know Trump's the best of the field. I don't go for lesser of evils, but he is a populist. He's anti-globalist. What he's saying won't be dialed back. It's damaging. That's why I think he's real. But regardless, we don't just stop there. We start at the states, the local levels. We fight at every front. We fight with the decisions we make of what media we support, what grocery stores we support, what stores we support. We aggressively live our lives to build up independent Americana liberty-based systems. John in Ohio, then we've got Manny and Mash and Victor in Florida and Cody in South Carolina. Cody's been holding the longest, then I'll go to Manny. Cody in South Carolina, you're on the air.
Hey, Jones, pleasure to talk to you, brother.
Thank you, sir.
I'm just a little fired up. You got to talking about the homo cake baker scandal for Whole Foods. Now I just want to comment and say that what you and your team have been reporting on the past couple of years with these cultural fascists taking over society, absolutely spot on target. I'm a recent college graduate from Clemson University down here in South Carolina. I think they did your Tangy Tangerine study with the cancer cells in the stomach. But anyways, we're actually being invaded right now by social justice warriors, and they're, you know...
Their new business is to sue people for their free speech. For those who don't know, pastor to drop lawsuit against Whole Foods over anti-gay slur on cake. You have to read to the bottom of the article in the Austin American Statesman, also on all the other stations, to learn that they have the surveillance footage of him leaving with the cake over the register and over the bakery without the word fag on it. And now he's, quote, apologized, but didn't say he did it. He wants them to drop their lawsuit against him. Again, but then the leftist won't even admit it was a false flag staged event. It should be man tried to frame Whole Foods in part of social justice warrior jihad. But no, they won't give you a real headline, will they?
No, not at all. And here at Clemson, we're kind of coming under fire from these social justice warriors for having one of our founders back in 1889 was a white supremacist. We're a Reconstruction state, and as you know, there's that in our culture. It's in our history, unfortunately. But they've capitalized on this fact, and it's a big scandal. Somebody actually hung a bunch of bananas on an African American history sign on campus, and everybody lost their minds. It was insane. So Black Lives Matter did a huge protest on campus for about a week, and I was like, you know, I listen to you a lot for the past 4 years. And exactly what you said, it's usually an inside job. So I got to investigating. Turns out, word on the street, the bananas were hung by a black guy. Surprise, surprise. So out of this, what do they get? They got a bunch of petition, a bunch of protests on campus.
Sure, well, let's expand on that. I mean, I'll be honest with you. I never heard, except in liberal media, the stuff about watermelon and fried chicken. That's what people eat in the South. I mean, I grew up at grandma's house or when my parents were having a party with watermelon and fried chicken. You go to a fried chicken place in any city, there's white people, black people, Hispanics. It's super delicious. It's super fattening. I mean, it's crazy now. And then Bill Clinton, who I hate and who is a racist and who did all the minimum sentencing and all this, doesn't matter. He was in, what was it, Alabama, was called to a church to do a public, you know, feed deal, and they had fried chicken at it. And they said he was racist. There's nothing racist about fried chicken. There it is. Bill Clinton visits. Oh, it was Kentucky. I was going from memory. Literally serves fried chicken to black people. Well, I mean, that's just crazy. I mean, everybody eats fried chicken. It's crazy. But see, Northerners don't. So that's where all this fried chicken watermelon thing comes from, is black people moved from the South to the North in the last 100 years and brought that with them. And Northerners thought chitlins and all this other food was weird, and so it got had an African connotation. Well, that's just what people in the South eat. I grew up eating collard greens, and I grew up eating fried chicken, and I grew up eating gizzards, and I grew up eating pig's feet, and I grew up eating corn on the cob, and I grew up eating beans and cornbread. Cornbread and iced tea took the place of pills and 42. It's actually pills and 100 proof, but the point is that this is the mindless garbage. We're all losing our rights. We're all losing our basic liberties. We're all going under global government, and we're obsessing over fried chicken and watermelon. And it's such oppressive brainwashing that when I get a watermelon at the grocery store and put it in my cart, or I'm frying chicken, now everything has this connection that it's mind control. I appreciate your call. It's absolute, total mind control. I fry chicken probably once a month, folks. I get a bunch of fresh organic chicken, shove it into some, I just love it. Bread it up, pow. Has nothing to do with what color I am. It's crazy town. But it's just like people in the North think everybody's riding horses and is racist and, you know, and that we don't even have cars here in the South. NASA is based here. The superconducting super colliders, the nuclear reactors. There's more technology in the South than in the North. I mean, it's just brainwashing. By the way, I love Northerners. It's all this divide and conquer garbage. We'll be back. Stay with us. By the way, the Washington Post is reporting that Whole Foods isn't going to continue their suit against the guy that went in there, got a cake, put fag on it, and then said that they did it to him. Try to get money. They're just going to let people pull that type of stuff on them because they're liberal. It's more social justice warrior stuff. They don't want to, you know, discourage doing that. Just don't do it to Whole Foods. Do it to the mom and pop bakery. And I'm not out to get Whole Foods, but you know, I'm sick of these social justice warriors and their false flags. I've almost never seen a case where they didn't stage it. And that's the type of stuff that goes on. Now, I want to go to Manny and Mash, then John in Ohio. Then we'll go to Victor, Frank, and Dave, and others. There's a bunch of callers here. Let's go ahead now and go to Manny and Mash. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hello. Pleasure to speak with you. I try to keep this short and sweet. So basically what I wanted to put out there was the supposed most transparent president in U.S. history has we the people bound by 19 executive orders that are hidden from us. Now, what I want to get your take on is how do you see that in light of where we're at now with all the elections and everything going on?
Well, that's right. I think it's more than 19 of his executive orders are secret, and the summaries on some of them are like, for any emergency, including economic, total martial law, Congress suspended for 6 months, President Obama as supreme leader. And the Republicans have given him authority over the economy to the next president as well to spend any money they want and not have to go get authorization from Congress. So the entire season, the entire atmosphere is one of dictatorial power. It's unprecedented.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree more. But the second part I wanted to bring up to that was, do you see those possibly being Obama's keys to the possible implementation of Sharia law here in this country?
Sure. I mean, I don't think we're there yet. They're going to bring in tens of millions more Muslims from radical areas that can't even get along with each other in their own countries. They're going to bring in the invaders from all over the Middle East that came into Syria, allow them to go into Turkey, into Europe, into the U.S., then set them up, give them more welfare than citizens, more than Social Security recipients. That's in the Associated Press. And just set them up as a protected class. Then we'll all have to comply with them, or we're hate mongers, just like Europe's doing. So that's really the long slide. Now, Europe's further along. They brought in 5 million the last couple of years. And so in Europe, they are being put under Sharia law in many cities. Many cities, are like Paris, are no-go areas in most areas for Europeans. Anybody else is acceptable. But you know, the left has combined forces to create racism for divide and conquer. So then the national state can come in and basically have martial law and a civil emergency permanently to protect all the other subgroups from the incompatible Muslims that months before were murdering everyone around them in the Middle East. So this is a designed takedown of Europe. It's a military operation. It's going very, very well, devastating Europe. I appreciate your call. Let's jam in one more call. Let's talk to Dave in PA. Dave, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, I got the Hillary for prison t-shirt. Just love it. Boy, do I get some looks from a lot of people when I wear that out. But
thank you.
The reason why I'm calling you there, Alex, here earlier on Best Common Sense Coalition program, a gentleman caller called in and said something about that slimy little creature, Newt Gingrich, wanting to be Donald Trump's vice president.
That has been admitted. That has been admitted, and I don't like the idea. Look, he sees the tea leaves. He's a smart globalist, and he wants to attach himself to Trump, and Trump's being friendly. But I think that's a very, very bad move. I wouldn't like that. What do you say?
Stop that slimy little creature.
Well, I mean, he is a globalist who poses as a conservative, but the folks know his real record. He's dangerous. What do you think?
It's just another one of them rhinos, you know? It's like we got to get rid of these people that have caused the problems and correct the problems, because these people should be taken and brought up on treason charges for what they've done to their
Absolutely.
Country.
We'll be back in 70 seconds. Thank you, Dave. More calls straight ahead. Third
Thank
hour.
Thank you for listening.
70 seconds out at InfoWars.com. Please spread the word. Let's go ahead and go right back to your phone calls. I want to go to Frank and John and Victor and Carlos and Joe. Holding the longest is a man in Ohio. John wants to talk about the robotic police force in Japan. I remember reading about that 10 years ago. They planned it for a couple of years. They got robots on the streets now. That ties into some of this other news I'm going to get to later. But John in Ohio, thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. You're on the air.
Well, Alex, this is the whole thing. And I diagnosed this from the first day when I heard about the racial profiling thing. I said, what they are setting up, the elite are setting up a position where they could say all human being police officers are evil, therefore we need to replace it with artificial intelligence, which would not see race. It would just see
brother, you're absolutely
like
singing my song. It's right out of the new RoboCop, tells you exactly what they're planning, and then it takes human decision-making out because they're sick of police and military over and over again, not going along with tyranny. And so that's why the whole demonization, the whole UN program, the Strong Cities Initiative, they admit is to, quote, federalize the police, take over the military, ruin it with women in frontline combat, so it all goes obsolete, so we accept autonomous robots. That's an admitted plan. And I'm trying to get that word out to people. Go ahead.
I just wanted to ask you something. Years ago, in the year 1783, there was a Colonel Jonathan Williams who supposedly wrote a book called Legions of Satan that was about the Illuminati plan to completely destroy humanity, because their eventual plan is to exterminate all the races of man, not just whites. And Jonathan Williams, who was a colonel in Washington's army, wrote this book. Senator Joe McCarthy quotes this in 1956. Eustace Mullins quotes this book. I have called the Antiquarian Society. I have called everywhere trying to find this, and all they can tell me is the book doesn't exist.
Well, if you Google it, it says Jonathan Williams, Legions of Satan, and they, you know, break down supposedly pieces of it. But I know that there have been a lot of books that are supposedly written that people can't find. But I will dig into that and look into that. All I know is, there was another book written called Proofs of This Conspiracy that went out of print, and then I do have a copy of it. It was reprinted and put out by Mark Deich, where they talk about criminal groups using the Masonic system. Not that the Masons were bad, but evil groups using the secrecy of it, the compartmentalized nature of it, to set up their organized crime takeover. And not to eliminate the people, but to actually dumb them down and dominate them. So regardless, we are under a criminal conspiracy to dumb down humanity. What do you say, John?
I say exactly right, but like I said, they are taking stuff right out of the Library of Congress. In fact, just like the Albert Pike letter, which people claim don't exist, the cardinal, the archbishop of the nation of Chile saw the letter in 1925 and put it in a book, The Secrets of Freemasonry Unveiled.
Sure, supposedly at the Naval War College there in London. Look, all I know is Pike wrote a bunch of stuff. I've read some of his books. He was the founder of the Klan, the head of the Masons. He admitted he worshipped Lucifer. He's one of these guys Washington warned us about. And then he did talk about world wars, bringing in world government, and that's the globalist plan. So for 100 years, we've been hearing about this letter. Whoever said this 100 years ago knew what they were talking about regardless. You see what I'm saying?
Exactly. You're so right on that, Alex. It's good to finally talk to you again. Thank you.
God bless you, John. Thanks for holding to bring up those points. We're going to come back from break. I'm making a lot of calls today. We're going in order of who's been holding the longest. Victor, and then Frank, Carlos, Mike in Hawaii, and others. Toll free number to join us, 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. We do things different here, so it's Open Line Tuesday. Got a bunch of guys coming up throughout the week. Stay with us, Infowars.com/newsletter to get key inside intel. InfowarsNews.com, PrisonPlanet.tv, $1,595 a month membership. 20 people can use it. That helps fund our operation. I want to thank all the members of PrisonPlanet.tv. You help get all of it out to the general public. We put a lot of the content on YouTube, Facebook, for the general population. But you're the folks that help with the seed money and get the ball rolling. So I want to commend you for being part of the info war to defend free humanity. This is just the beginning. I wanted to talk about the fact that Roger Stone's coming on tomorrow. He only popped in for 10 minutes yesterday to talk all things 2016 and Trump. But there's a story out of Politico. Trump hires pollster Tony Fabrizio. And just from Stone, he points out that this is a fellow that's worked with him and Paul Manford. And they recruited him and that he's a good guy, a really good guy. And it's a win for Trump. And then another little bird was telling me about how Corey Lewandowski wanted Kellyanne Conway, former Cruz pollster. Fabrizio was Rand Paul's pollster. Fabrizio's a libertarian, he's a street fighter, and he's a winner. So a lot of the inside folks from the Trump camp are very, very proud of this new choice there. And when he's on tomorrow, I'll ask about the Kissinger stuff and more. So that's coming up. I want to go back to your calls until the bottom of the hour. And then I covered a record amount of news in the first hour, some of it in the second, but I'm really into the rest of this news because there's so much of it. I mean, here's one of them I want to hit. There is life after death. Scientists reveal shocked findings from groundbreaking study. That's in the Express. Magic mushrooms, London Telegraph, lift severe depression in trials, scientific trials. Going to church could help you live longer. Study finds, CBS News. That's just some of that interesting stuff I want to get to. Some of the positive things. I want to talk about the campaign. I want to get into also what I've been mentioning but haven't played yet, the Muslim groups saying we will destroy the blonde-haired blue eyes. We will take over. It's an absolutely wonderful thing, and it's just going to be so beautiful once this all happens. So that's coming up. But right now, let's go to your phone calls. Let's talk to Frank in North Carolina. Thanks for calling. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. I got something that I heard the other day I wanted to pass on to you, but real briefly, just a real quick joke on Southern food. See, I call one of these bars, these dives, and I ask them, you know, do they have pig's feet? And the guy said, yeah, we got pig's feet. And then you say, where do you buy your shoes?
Or like,
I love that joke.
Or it's like calling somebody and saying, is your refrigerator running? And they say yes, and you say, why don't you catch it?
Hey, I heard a great call on Friday the 13th on my local talk radio here. Now, the host promotes InfoWars, has been for over a decade. He never really says anything about you or what you talk about. He just says InfoWars. But anyway, he's been kind of, I don't know, man, he's strange. He's like really pro-agenda on this transgender in the bathrooms here in North Carolina, which is, you know, a major issue here in North Carolina right now.
Well, my issue is, I'm going to be honest. And a lot of my really conservative Christian friends, I'm Christian, but I mean, I don't hate people if it's consenting adults doing something. I'm not obsessed with that. A lot of folks are obsessed with it, you know, kind of have some issues, latent, you know, desires. But I don't like all these radical leftists attaching it to that agenda and trying to teach it to kids. That's sexualizing children. It's the state trying to get away with anything. And there's no debating that. So that's why I'm upset about it. Go ahead.
Well, a caller called in. It's about 20 minutes, maybe 15, 20 minutes in the third hour, three-hour show on Friday morning. And the caller just I missed the first part. I didn't hear his name, and I haven't gotten the chance to get on the Internet yet to listen to the call. But the call just blew me away and blew the host away. The host didn't know how to handle the call. The guy was very articulate. He spoke like an attorney. You could tell he was a conservative patriot, and he was not a cuck servitude. I mean, this guy, he was very articulate, very smart. You could tell he's probably more than likely he was very educated.
Sure, so tell me what he said. I want to hear it.
He's willing to stand up and fight. But he said, look, this is way bigger than, you know, defending or standing up for some perceived oppressed, minority. This is much bigger than that, but I can't do it justice. And like I said, I was sitting in traffic and a lot of distractions. But I heard.
But I mean, what did he say it was about?
I mean, he sounded like he was. He sounded like an InfoWars guy. He sounded like he might be a listener or something.
Well, is it about? It's clearly about federal control. It's about giving us faux rights because they're taking our real rights. It's about dividing people, and it's about sexualizing children to confuse their gender identity. It's a whole move to absolutely end fertility in this country, which is their admitted plan. I lay it all out in my film made 9 years ago. This is what they're doing.
Yeah, but is there any way people can I give some information out where, if any, you know, you got millions of
listeners? Yeah, just so you know, I don't care if radio shows get plugged where people say where something was at. I'm not one of those guys. I don't really screen calls. So if you want to say I was listening to this show and they said this, that's fine.
Anyway, it's Friday the 13th. It's the third hour of the show. It was the last caller in the first half hour of the show. It was about 15, 20 minutes into it. He let him talk for about 10, it seemed like 10, 15
Okay,
minutes.
What was the show so people can find it?
Okay, it's called The Keith Larson Show, LARSON, Keith Larson Show. It's on WBT Radio in Charlotte, North Carolina. You can go to the website and find the podcast for Friday the 13th.
I mean, the best thing for folks like you to do is get somebody to grab it, or you put it on YouTube. Media you think's interesting, magnify it. If millions of patriots start taking media that they think's important and magnifying local media, it becomes national, it becomes global media. That's what I originally did going back 20 years ago. Was it just local? I broke that stranglehold, and I would cover different local stories from around the country that normally wouldn't be a national platform. That's what Drudge does as well before I did. And that's where it's all at. I appreciate your call. Let's go ahead and take another one here. Let's talk to Victor in Florida. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. Thanks for taking my call. I am a Dominican immigrant from the capital, Santo Domingo, living in Florida, a.k.a. FEMA Region 4. And I just want to thank you for, you know, everything. I know you don't like that, but I just, you know, without you and your show and my brother bringing me, bringing the attention to your show, to me, I should say, it just helped me. And I purchased a bunch of your products.
Thank you, sir. I want to thank you. We're all in this together. I mean, I'm talking about stuff. You're waking up. You're supporting us. Thank you, sir. I want to thank you.
No problem. And, you know, I want to talk also. I just want to mention to everyone that's listening, we need to get out there in Cleveland, and we need to show up, and we need to show support for Trump. Because if we don't show up, you know those freaking social justice warriors are going to be there by the thousands. So we need to make sure that we're out there. And
absolutely. Patriots are always too busy working, taking care of their families. We're not grandstanders, but this country's in crisis. Everyone that can be needs to be in Cleveland at least one or two of the days. And believe me, we're going to outnumber the communists and the socialists and the Soros people. And don't worry, you know, the local government knows what scum they are. So they're going to be definitely between a rock and a hard place. We're going to be peaceful, but we're going to be there making sure they don't try to steal this election. And again, I don't like Bernie Sanders, but they're stealing it from him. He's really the winner. So it makes me upset that they would steal elections in front of us and try to act like it's normal. It's crazy.
Glad that you mentioned that, because I talk to a lot of people. And as I said, I'm an immigrant. That's why I said that, because I come from Dominican Republic. And every Latino, pretty much every Latino that I talk to that is my friend or just, you know, someone that I meet because I'm wearing my Hillary for Prison t-shirt, they're always like, you know, who are you voting for? I'm like,
you know, if I could vote, because I can't, I'm not a citizen, I'm legal, I would vote for Trump. And I try to advise everybody, and they just look at me like I got three heads. And it's like, you know, it's the mainstream media spewing out all their lies, as you know, 6% approval. And it's just, and I just try to slowly chip away. It's kind of like, it kind of brings you down when you see so many of your friends literally like the Walking Dead zombies. Seriously, that's how it is. It makes you kind of like, man, like, but I still keep pushing. You know, you got to kind of, you know, plant the seed, and hopefully, it'll grow on its own.
Well, I totally and absolutely agree with you, and that's what it comes all down to. And it's we the people that start the new trends. It's we the people that take action, and the system tries to counterfeit it or twist it or take it over. But if we just wake up and say no to this, it's game over. And yes, young people historically are where a lot of change comes from. There's a lot of great young people that end up saying no to things in the power structure they think are wrong. So starting in the 50s, really, the power structure started targeting the young people with fake revolutions and fake counterculture stuff that they could steer and control to break down society. And so now the young people are some of the most dumbed down, disconnected folks, and they absolutely believe mainstream pop TV is real. They don't watch news. They get their news from sitcoms, dramas, comic books, which are all just spewing globalism and multiculturalism and all this social justice warrior trash. And they show up at college as a freshman. They're bullied on, you know, their first meeting to be part of the social justice warriors. They're let into the club, and now they feel like they're part of a gang. And they're very, very sad people. But we shouldn't just laugh at them. We should really reach out to them and try to warn them about the hoax that's taking place. I mean, you can go to InfoWars.com. And get the video. It's also on drudgereport.com, the right-hand side, red linked. In fact, let me just show folks right now. You can go there, and you can see on the right-hand side where it's red linked, flashback Bill Clinton talking like Trump on immigration. And show that to him and say, do you understand that Mexico puts you in jail for 6 months to a year, forced labor, and beats you up if you're caught illegally there? I mean, it's incredible. They make Southwest Airlines flying into Cancun land the exact minute they say, or they'll turn the flight back. They tell them, the only place in the world, when the flights can take off from the U.S. I mean, if you're not there 30 minutes before, they don't let you on the plane in Mexico. They are the most arbitrary. But they're like, you got to have all our people and pay for everything or you're racist. It's mind control. I obsess over the last 20 years on air about turning your television off, putting your phones away, and getting out in nature, getting out in the forest, how essential that is. And that's why the feds are trying to shut down all the forest and the lands and trying to tell people not to be in them and harassing people at national parks. Incredibly rude, incredibly hateful in most areas now. And then even city parks, other areas, because they want you inside the house, bombarded by radiation and television, and their message is their false reality. They admit this is the plan. That's why they arrest parents all over the country when their 11 or 12-year-olds are playing in the backyard or across the street at the park. Washington Post, though, will now tell you about it because they're probably going to feel a surprise for this, that the world is round. Forest bathing is latest fitness trend to hit U.S. where yoga was 30 years ago. Oh, my gosh, the trendies gave it a name. They invented it. Doctors 200 years ago said, get out, get sunlight, take a walk in the woods. They call it forest bathing. Maybe the Washington Post will tell us about breathing and give it a name like bringing in the air or loving the atmosphere. Over thousands of years of human history, we have effectively become an indoor species. No, we haven't. That's only the last 50 years. Particularly for those of us trapped in the cubicle life, often the only times we regularly step foot outside is for our daily work commute or to run errands. Yeah, I live in a neighborhood by a big green belt and stuff, and I'm telling you, no one is on it. No one. No one. And I had some lady ask me once, aren't you afraid you'll get mugged? There's no one around there. It's safe. It's just these people have been total mental ill fear. But again, that they panic. Oh my gosh, I'm in the woods by a creek. In 2001, a survey sponsored by the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency found that on average, Americans spend 87% of their time indoors and 6% in an enclosed vehicle. However, a number of scientific studies emphasize, we've been talking about lately, that reveal the great outdoors promotes human health. Oh, what? Spending time in natural environments has been linked to lower stress levels? What? Improved working memory and feeling more alive, among other positive attributes, like having windows that even look out on trees helps. In an effort to combat, of course, Cass Sunstein, the White House science czar, wanted laws passed. He wrote white papers saying ban people that say you need 30 minutes of sunlight a week. He wants you arrested. He doesn't want you to have that sun. No, no, no. Brain damage sets in, depression. But Cass, you look at a photo of Cass Sunstein like a hyper predator, man. People say that's crazy to want to control reality and say the sun is evil. But if he can conquer the sun, he's conquered Earth. See, it's about you outrageously following his edict. Just like Karl Rove said, he controls reality. Can we put up Cass Sunstein on screen, please? A true wolf. In an effort to combat our indoor epidemic and reap these health benefits, a growing number of Americans have become followers of a Japanese practice called Shinri-yuku, coined by the Japanese Ministry of Agriculture, Forests, and Fisheries in 82. The word literally means and translates to taking in the forest atmosphere. Poor forest bathing. Cass Sunstein will probably say it hurts you. And refers to the process of soaking up the sights, smells, and sounds. Oh, man, I can't wait to get in the forest. I go for nighttime walks under the moon, too. And refers to the process of soaking up the sights, smells, and sounds of natural setting to promote psychological and physiological health. What you got to do is, you got to be up safe, you know, treks and stuff, but you ought to climb hills and mountains at night when the stars are out. And, you know, go out to State Park, National Park, it's nighttime, and then nighttime, go up a big hill, you know, safe route up a mountain, get up there on the top, and it's just, you're up there, and this wisp of clouds and the moon and the stars, and it's just like, whoa. So better than any drug, folks. It's all waiting for you right now. So is getting enough vitamin C. So is getting enough sunshine. So is getting proper organic vitamin B12. So is getting D3. So is getting your vitamins and minerals. And it's all waiting, just like the forest. The vitamin mineral fusion, absolutely essential to absorb it all. The secret 12, methylcobalamin, the best out there. The vitamin D3, winter sun, the iodine, the pure, truly atomic, original iodine. Doesn't have the same effect when it's all bound and tied to other garbage, is what the chemists tell me. And all I know is other stuff didn't do this. It's amazing. And you fund the broadcast while you do it. InfoWarsLife.com. I didn't even mean to plug. I'm just doing it right now because I was going to do it after this break. But it's just, it's right there. You need sunlight. By the way, you will die from too much sunlight. You will die without it. And the studies show you'll die quicker with no sunlight than you'll die if you get too much. Okay? Bare minimum, 30 minutes. Cross your full body once a week is the minimum. That's why everybody gets so sick in the winter. Is the main reason is not just indoors. There's no sun. Your vitamin D3 runs out in a month. You've got to have sun. When I was a kid, my dad used to get me up about 3:30 in the morning. We'd eat breakfast and stuff, and then he'd purposely have us walk about a mile, 2 miles, sometimes further, to a big ranch. You have that luxury out in East Texas through the woods to the deer stand. And by the time you got there in your overalls and stuff, you'd be sweating even if it was cold. And it's just good to turn you on and switch you on. Because if you got in a car and drove out to a deer stand, you know, you'd be half asleep when you got there and fall asleep. But you wouldn't be if you walked a couple miles in the dark. And people don't do that. They don't do what humans always did before. It's just crazy. And that's what's therapeutic. And the system knows that. So that was an exciting article that we covered earlier. All right, I'm going to come with a few more calls and get back into the news. This story just went up on InfoWars.com from Kit Daniels. Trump hires libertarian for campaign. Former Rand Paul pollster Tony Fabrizio joins Trump 2016. So that is a good sign right there. I want to get him on the broadcast. In fact, Stone was telling me 3 months ago to get Fabrizio on the show. He's never got around to it, so he'll be busy and hard to get on now. But, Nico, let's get him on. So that is certainly exciting on that front. Right now, let's go back to your phone calls. Who's been holding the longest here? That would be Carlos in Pennsylvania, then Frank, then Mike, and others. Go ahead. You're on the air, Carlos.
Hey, Alex. First time caller, long time listener. And I think the problem is you haven't taken your vaccines and, you know, your GMOs and fluoride lately.
Well, I know this. I'm not the prettiest guy around, but I'm not bad looking. And if I'd taken all that, I'd probably look like, you know, even worse. I mean, I see people that are all into that. I hear people always at restaurants going, I get my flu shot every year. And you look at them, they look like they're dead. I don't care if they're 25 or 70. They look like hell. And, of course, the studies show 3 flu shots doubles your chances of Alzheimer's. That's CBS News. I mean, oh, it's so sad. Go ahead. Sorry.
Yeah, no, it's okay. I moved out here from New York City last year, and I'm also, like the last caller, I'm Puerto Rican. I'm Hispanic, too. And I go to school out here in Lancaster, PA, or Millersville. And it's amazing because every time Trump comes up, everybody has something mean to say, but if it's Bernie Sanders, oh, I touched his hand. Oh, I love him. Oh, he's so amazing. He you know, he's the next coming of Christ, and it's just, it's so sad.
Yeah, look at, I would ask folks, why is Venezuela so horrible now under socialism? I mean, don't they understand that under, quote, communism or socialism, most people are literal slaves?
Yeah, I don't understand it. I mean, it's more clear than ever that things are just going down the drain, and the things being stolen, the election, just it's all rigged. I mean, come on. Like, I don't understand.
Well, let me show you this article. Carlos, great points. Thanks for calling in. Why don't you show your friends this article, another one by our prolific Kit Daniels, Infowars.com, May 17, 2016, today. Socialism, Bernie Sanders' wife bankrupts college, forcing its closure. Bernie pushes free college while his wife bankrupts school. Burlington College, which took on heavy debt during the tenure of Bernie Sanders' wife, is closing down. Well, that's why the banks love socialists. The closure of the Liberal Arts College of Vermont was blamed directly on Jane Sanders, who bankrupted the school as president from 04 to 2011. Founded in 72 as an informal gathering of students, Burlington College grew into a small, regionally accelerated liberal arts college but financial strain and academic probation created by the ambitious but ill-fated expansion under then-president Jane Sanders onto a new campus of prime waterfront led to the school's demise, the Burlington Free Press reported. The guy didn't have a paying job till he was 40. You got big corporations, hundreds of billions of dollars. They're the ones funding socialism because they're exempt from it. All right, let me get back to your calls. I really need to get to the stacks of news I've mentioned but haven't hit yet. I need to cover it. Let's go ahead and talk to Frank in Louisiana. Frank, you're on the air. Thank you for calling.
Alex, I have just two quick questions. I'll make a quick statement. I have one that the Globus in their algorithm, they have that, they can't have a superpower as the United States, so they're going to try to bring us down. We know that. And my two questions is, Trump, now that he's come to the forefront, I think in their algorithm, he's the number two obstacle that they face for completing their plan. And do you think that they're going to pull the trigger on us rather than later, now or later, because of Trump? And my second question, do you think we'll even have a 2016 election with all the things going on?
They know that Trump is a manifestation of rising nationalist free market populism. So rising nationalist free market populism is what I would call this phenomenon. And so Trump is one and the same, their fear of the public. Whether he's real or not, and I think he's real, but we'll see. The manifestation and his popularity is real. And that the media's full attack can't defeat him shows they're out of bullets. And so, yes, I think they're going to accelerate their program because it's a good 10 years behind or more. And they're taking the gloves off now because everything else hasn't worked through desperation. So we are having victories, but it's also very dangerous, and the big fight is just now starting. And so I would say they could do anything to destabilize us. I mean, bringing 5 million radical jihadists out of war zones into Europe and letting them rape and murder whoever they want is hardcore. And they're setting the same thing up here. So war with Russia, economic collapse, false flags blamed on us. Race wars being started. I mean, the sky's the limit. They got everything primed up, and they've got a handful of really nasty cards to play. And so, intellectually, I'm concerned. In my gut, I'm concerned. What do you think?
Well, I'm just concerned, too, because they have so many trigger points. They could, and, you know, the Middle East, you know, Kim Jong-un, we got so many things they could do, and the illness of these guys is just beyond my comprehension. And I'm for Trump. I'm all for him, and I hope that he can make it through this thing and survive it. But I don't know. I don't think that the regular public out there is really in tune to how close we are for this thing to explode on us.
Brother, you're on target, and they're so upset that our founders laid down the Second Amendment and other things like that, like the First Amendment, that are such obstacles in their way, but they just seem to think they can run through it, and they're going to push and push and push, and I guess try to have a civil war where we destroy the local government, the local police, if they're dumb enough to follow orders, and then they've defeated both their enemies. And I just, we need to reach out to the police, the military, and just till they're flooded with information, which they are now, so they understand exactly what's happening so they don't go along with this, because they are destroying this country if they aid the globalists in bringing in a true occupational force. I mean, this is like joining the Nazis if you were French in 1940, 1941. Great points, Frank. Thank you. I'm going to go to Mike in Hawaii after the break, and Dante, Joe, Otter, and others. But let me start getting to some of the news I mentioned before we run out of time. I mentioned this with the articles up on Infowars.com. There's videos. It's simply amazing. More of these videos come out every day of the illegal invaders running around screaming jihad, beating people up and raping. But no-go areas, huge increase in attacks on police in Sweden. They've told the police, do not report when a Muslim rapes a woman or attacks somebody. I mean, they even kill families and get away with it. France has declared civil emergency as the highways are untenable, with new footage every day of just thousands overrunning trucks and cars, robbing them and stealing families and then beating people up and dragging women off to be raped. I mean, it is bedlam. And the police are always there helping, making sure it happens. I mean, that's leftist police, folks. These are sick, 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 sick evil people on average. A new report from the researchers and police in Sweden, this is Breitbart, in Sweden has revealed a huge increase in crimes and assaults carried out on paramedics, firefighters, and the police. So the police submitting to these folks have only encouraged it. Swedish police have been attacked in 14 so-called no-go zones with knives and hand grenades and are bracing for more violence this summer. A new report from researchers, and that's when they're allowed to file it, it's much worse, in Sweden. In fact, let's show some of the civil emergency in France. You can type in France declares emergency on its highways from immigrants, and then show attacks on French drivers by the migrants. I mean, the footage is unbelievable. Continuing, you can just type it into YouTube, listeners. You can see it for yourselves. So when I tell the crew to pull it up, you can pull it up yourself, too. There's just hours and hours of it every day, just thousands of videos. It's unbelievable. Continuing, a new report from researchers and police in Sweden has revealed a huge increase in crimes. Certain neighborhoods and towns often known for high migrant populations, you'll have like 100 citizens and 700 migrants, invaders, have been designated as unsafe for emergency crews to respond to fires and medical emergencies without armed police escort. You know, if aliens from outer space landed with ray guns like Mars Attacks, I tell you, our media would call them migrants and tell them, line up in front of your house and let them come by and free you. Being shot by an energy beam and disintegrated would be called a freeing moment. And Hillary would be on TV saying, be nice, come to the front of your house, put your hands up, you're going to be freed, and your energy will go to Hale-Bopp Comet. And if Hillary said, give your children barbiturates and vodka and put on Nike tennis shoes, the average liberal would kill their child. I'm not joking. These are cult members. Knives, projectiles, stabbings, murders, grenades, emergency services workers have been targets for attacks in Sweden for years, but now it's exploding. Cops love it because they're not allowed to do anything. And so once they submit, that's the end of it. But don't run. We are your friends. In fact, can we back this up? This is actual footage from Sweden just in. Can we back this up with audio for TV and radio listeners? This is actual footage in from Sweden, and they've decided to do a pilot program in Las Vegas. It's like this new Muslim video they put out saying, you know, we're like Trump, be nice to us. It's like, it's so cynical and dumbed down, and the whole body language is just oppressive. Because in the Middle East, folks, they constantly are backstabbing each other, constantly, you know, manipulating. And there's some nice countries like Jordan and Syria and Iraq were somewhat better. But, I mean, it just is total barbarism. If your wife talks back, you can just slit her throat or pour gasoline on her. So, look, don't run. We are your friends. We just put up some YouTube footage that people put comments up about what multiculturalism does and where they say it comes from. But this is the... In fact, we have some audio of this, of the guns and the burning and the shooting, and then just mix it in with the Mars attacks real quick for folks, because that's pretty important. Don't run, we are your friends. So we'll have some of that audio of why I was paralleling that to you.
Don't run, we are your friends.
Women running, people being vaporized. And then here's real footage. Don't run, we are your friends. I love how the Anglo reporter even covers her head up so she didn't get knocked upside the head. They're just burning, shooting things, people shooting guns in the air. Don't run, we are your friends. They're holding mortars, the big, like, 20-shot mortars in their hands and shooting them. Just, oh, no, no, no. Don't run, we are your friends. Women with their kids running, pit bulls. I love how the jihadists, like, merge with the Mac Daddy pimp culture, too. I mean, I guess, you know, that's just all part of this cultural warfare stuff. Okay, let's move on to the next video. Paul Joseph Watson has a report. I'll narrate when he's playing the jihad videos. Video up on Infowars.com. Muslim scholar celebrates extinction of blue-eyed, blonde-haired Germans. Germans in the meeting celebrate and applaud. You cannot make this stuff up. The story's up on Infowars.com. Here it is.
Islam scholar Lamyar Kador said on German television that being German in future will not mean having blonde hair and blue eyes, but being a migrant and wearing a hijab.
Being
German will mean having a migration background in the future. This is what joining German will mean in the future. No more blue eyes, white hair, claiming we're all German. Of course, she doesn't have to wear a beekeeper suit, though. She's one of the controller females. Being German also means wearing a hijab. Having dark hair, this is what German means today. Of course, the Germans applaud. Yes! Kill us!
The German audience applauded the eradication of their own people. Because supporting the extinction of your own race is far less of a burden than, God forbid, being called a racist. Kador was responsible for publishing the first German translation of the Quran for children and adults. She also introduced Islamic education in German public schools. This was such a huge success that it led to five of her students traveling to Syria to join ISIS. Leftists and Muslims celebrating the demographic suicide of a nation is a common theme. Green Party politician Stephanie von Berg said it was a good thing that Germans would become a minority in major cities.
Our society will change. Our city will change radically. I hold that in 20, 30 years, there will no longer be German majorities in our city. Look, it's all women in power, too, slitting their own country's throat. And I will make it very clear, especially towards these right-wingers. Look, it's all run by women.
Imam Sheikh Mohammed Ayed also gave a speech in which he asserted that Muslims should use the migrant crisis to breed with European citizens and conquer their countries by taking advantage of the fact that Europeans have lost their fertility.
We will give them fertility. We will breed children with them. Because we shall conquer their countries.
Leftist German politician Gregor Gysi implied that Germans who opposed the migrant influx were Nazis, and that it was good the Nazis didn't have many children.
Because of our history between 35 and 45, we are obliged to treat refugees properly. The refugees almost all joined Hitler, by the way. Oh, and by the way, every year more native Germans die than they were before. That's very fortunate. It's because the Nazis are not good at having offspring. This decline of Germans is why we so deepen the immigration.
The true agenda behind multiculturalism is revealed. There is no multi in multiculturalism. This is about big government and Islamists working together to bring in millions of Muslim migrants who will then vote for more big government. The complete decimation of the host culture and the freedoms and prosperity that came with it is a small price to pay.
Well, lots of another devastating report on InfoWars.com. Get it out to everybody. We'll be back. There's a bunch of mainstream news articles I've got here in my stack. They're up on InfoWars.com. They're up on Drudge as well. Sexual roulette, where you go to a party, a sex party, and there's like 10 people and one person has HIV. And now heterosexuals are getting into catching HIV. There's a Daily Mail. Sex roulette parties where one person is secretly HIV positive and nobody's allowed to use condoms are on the rise, warn doctors. Now, I would tell people 17, 18 years ago about bug chasers that I read about in Rolling Stone magazine. They interviewed people in San Francisco that wanted to catch HIV to be trendy. And now it's gone on to heterosexuals. This is nihilistic craziness. And these people aren't going to want HIV later when they're getting cancer and dying and stuff. That's what it does, is turn off your immune system. It just makes me so upset. I mean, we want to be healthy. We want to be happy. We don't want to give in to the misery. For God's sakes, we want to take care of the children. Turn off the TV. Turn off the video games. Take them for a walk. Go kayaking. Go swimming. Get out in nature. Go stargazing. Go catch fireflies. Take my kids firefly catching tonight. They're all over the place. They love doing it, even the older one. I mean, it's just crazy. And just care about something. But see, the more sex, the more partying, it's got to be more corrupt, more weird. That's because something's wrong with you. I never get tired of just good, wholesome things. And it doesn't mean that I haven't had a wild life, you know, growing up. I'm not bragging about that, but it's just so destructive to see what's going on. So crazy. Mike in Hawaii, thanks for holding her on the air worldwide.
Alex. Hey, what's up, Alex? Oh, first time, long time.
Well, thank you for calling, brother.
For me, the selection has been great with regards to talk show hosts because it has exposed those establishment guys, and I totally appreciate you coming out against Beck the past couple months. But
thank you.
What's up with Hannity? I mean, I feel he's been consistent, but what's the deal with him kissing Gingrich's ass? I mean,
Hannity's always been, Hannity, every time I tune in, which is like once every 2 months, I rarely listen to Hannity, but I listen to him sometime when I'm off doing work and I flip to the channels, hear what talk radio's doing. I almost always hear Gingrich on his show. So I mean, he must be on like every day or something. I always hear Newt Gingrich on his show. So I don't really follow it. I know Hannity's been doing some better stuff opposing globalism lately. So that's good. I don't want to be enemies with any of these talk show hosts, but what do you think?
I don't know, because I feel he's been doing a pretty good job lately and he's been consistent.
Let's just say this. He knows his audience is patriot. He knows they're waking up. He knows where his bun is buttered. And so that's why we build it, they will come. We don't put up with globalist garbage, they won't spew it because no one will go along with it. It's like Catalan in Spain. 87% or whatever it was, 89%, I forget the number, it's like in the high 80s, voted for secession. Spain may be able to block it a few years, but they'll never stop it. You can't block it when 80% of people say no bueno. Can't do it.
All right. Love you, Alex.
Love you too, brother. I'm going to go to break here and come back and take a few more calls before David Knight takes over. But by the way, this is big news. I should have been ringing this from the rafters. In fact, they gave it to me 30 minutes ago and I didn't mention it, but it's up on Drudge. See, Drudge gets it. Unanimous. Senate approves bill letting 9/11 families sue Saudi. It's also up on InfoWars.com. It's from The Hill. The Senate on Tuesday approved legislation that would allow 9/11 victims' family of terror attacks to sue Saudi Arabia, defying vocal opposition from the White House and Saudi's threat of $850 billion being pulled out of the U.S. The upper chamber approved the justice action sponsored by the Terrorism Act unanimous consent. And one big problem is Chuck Schumer is an anti-gun, anti-liberty guy who helped cover up the truth of 9/11. The New York senator, the senior senator, now supports this legislation. So, see, he can't even stop it. Now let's see the 28 pages come out. Weren't those supposed to come out today? The head of the CIA was supposed to release them. Did that happen? Did a tree fall in the forest? Didn't make a sound so nobody heard it? Hey, look at this. I forgot this headline. 22% of refugees in Minnesota positive for TB. That's okay. Just spread it. And they admit TB's exploding. Drug resistant. Hey, you want you and your kids to die? Don't be racist. Have the foreigner cough on you and die. It's fun. It's trendy. Come on. InfoWars.com. Help spread the word. InfoWars.com/newsletter. Hillary Clinton came out and said that Donald Trump's campaign is basically a suicide mission the other day, literally stealing my term. But let me tell you, tyrants historically are on a suicide mission, too. What happens when the unmovable object comes into contact with the unstoppable force? History shows you're not even made of the stuff of good folks are. You're not even as good as we are. You'll be defeated, globalist. I want to go to some more phone calls here now. Let's go to Joe in California. Thanks for holding. You're on the air.
Oh, well, thank you very much for taking my call, Alex. Been a long-time listener, and hands down, you are one of the most legit individuals I've ever listened to in radio.
But, well, thank you. Your phone's degrading, so talk right into your receiver.
Okay. All right. Well, I hope this is better. The Paul Joseph Watson video I saw earlier, I actually caught that before the show, and it's enraging. And I'm coming more and more to the conclusion that these people cannot be reasoned with. And I don't like what's going to happen to Europe in the future, because these people, they're laughing now, but they're not going to be laughing when enough people get, you know, get pissed off and decide to take action that won't be pretty for them. And I'm afraid that's going to happen here, too, with the Bernie people.
Sure, sure. It's a form of self-mutilation, which is on the rise. The more decadent a society becomes, the more self-mutilation increases. And when you bring in third world populations that are incompatible and giggle about it, it's like full-grown adults, it's popular now to wear diapers. Yeah, you know, so it's just all mental illness. I appreciate your call. Great points. Let's go ahead and talk to Otter in Mass. Otter, thanks for calling.
Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Okay, sorry. I changed phones to make sure I'd have a better one.
You're loud and clear, brother. Thank you. From Massachusetts.
Cool. So yesterday you had Tosh Pumley on. It occurs to me that if we know that there's a maneuver going on, if the robber barons have got some up that's moving, and we know about it, maybe we ought to start spreading the word even more and maybe think about getting people out there blocking the roads.
And that's a good idea. They listed the Marine Corps base where they've got the weapons. It's all slated to ship to the drug cartels and then to ISIS. And people blown the whistle. Folks have been attacked at the base. One friend of the colonel is one of the whistleblowers. And they're ready to talk to Congress. Congress won't talk to them. They're just going to ship the anti-tank missiles and machine guns and hand grenades directly to Al-Qaeda, which is now called ISIS, and we have all these high-level whistleblowers on telling folks, and they're killing Border Patrol and people over it, and this is a life-and-death situation, and it's just more entertainment for the average trendy. They just think it's funny.
My text down, so I'm getting you on shortwave out of Tennessee. They should get a high time. It seems to me that I missed some of what you were saying with him yesterday because it's intermittent, so it just seemed like, well, maybe this ought to be boosted, and we ought to. I figure you're probably going to end up having reporters around there around that time.
Sure, sure. You're saying you were listening on shortwave, you couldn't hear everything?
Yeah, I didn't catch all of it. Unfortunately, you know, this particular location.
Sure, no, I understand. There. Yeah, no, we don't know. I think we have like one affiliate goes into Massachusetts, unfortunately. We got like seven or eight affiliates in California. You know, a lot of affiliates in certain states, but not, we're not too good on the East Coast. We've got some there in New York and other areas. But thank you so much, Otter. I appreciate you calling in. That's why it's important for everybody that tunes in or watches the video at InfoWars or articles. People need this info. There, I mean, that Fast and Furious stuff yesterday was the biggest breaking news in the six-year history. I mean, it was explosive, dangerous, insane, over the top. All right, I'm out of time. I'm sorry to Jeffrey and Jeremy and Dante and others. David Knight's coming up. I got a sneaking suspicion. I don't want to take your calls, but that's up to him. Look at this article. 22% of resettled refugees in Minnesota test positive for tuberculosis. I have another article that TV's exploding across the country. And, of course, you bring people in from Pakistan and Syria, the poorest people, most of them that were invaders into Syria, and they've got hardcore drug-resistant TB from Africa, you name it, and they're just wandering around hacking and coughing and getting welfare. And then they admit they're in the public schools right next to your kid, and your kid gets TB. I mean, it's how you sabotage a country. And they're doing a great job. We're under military and scientific attack. And InfoWars.com is trying to resist it. David Knight, straight ahead. God bless you all.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host on this fourth hour, May 17th, 2016, of the Alex Jones Show. We're going to cover some news here. We're also going to go to some of our callers. We've got Jeremy in California. Hang on. I want to talk to you. You saw the report about the BLM. Harry Reid, you have some comments you want to make on that. And we do have a victory to celebrate. We had a Wyoming rancher beat the EPA. And that's something to celebrate about, because it is truly, if you're not familiar with this story, we'll go back and we'll let you know what happened with this. Also, we're going to give you instructions later in the program on how to beat your wife properly. So beating the EPA and beating your wife, that's what's coming up on the news today. We're also going to talk about the primary coming up tomorrow, what's going on within the Democrat Party. Very interesting news there. And, of course, every day brings more news about how they're going to roll out self-driving cars, self-driving trucks. What you're seeing at our airports, just understand, that's just a prelude to complete control of our transportation. It's the TSA is not the Airport Security Administration. They are the Transportation Security Administration. We've told you about this for years. Told you about the Viper teams, that they would roll out the bus stations or set up roadblocks at various places. They are going to use technology, folks, to do a complete control grid on our transportation. And you want to know what it's going to look like? It's going to be the worst aspects of the DMV and the TSA. They're going to combine that together. They're going to make it virtually impossible for you to travel. And they're going to take over cars. They're going to make it impossible for you to own a car. They're going to make it very difficult for you to travel. They will control all access. They will tax you. They will track you. They will force you into the cities. And that's what this report we're going to talk about here. If you've seen the report that Rob Jacobson and I did about Obama's land grab via executive order using an ancient, misusing, I should say, an ancient antiquities act to take over these monuments. The first time it was used was they took 2 acres, and it was a very familiar landmark that you've all seen in the Spielberg film Close Encounters, okay? That only took 2 acres. And a Devil's Tower. I had to think about what that was. But now they're out there taking millions of acres and doing it all over the place, even extending. They're going to be extending, it was announced at the end of the week, the Grand Canyon, taking parts of that, but they're not really protecting property in Arizona that they set apart that truly was about Indian history, Indian religion, and recreation, if people want to talk about that. So first I want to tell you about the, and then we'll go to our caller, Jeremy in California. I want to tell you what happened with a rancher today. This is a story on New American Wyoming. Rancher fights the feds and wins. He's been freed from millions of dollars in EPA fines. Now, this is 2 years ago. This is a rancher, Andy Johnson. He was in Wyoming. The guy had 8 acres. 8 acres. He's not a wealthy rancher. You don't have to hate him because you think he's wealthy. I can tell you the Bundys are not wealthy. The ranchers out there are not wealthy. They work really hard. But you think that everybody's Ben Cartwright if you live in the cities, okay? Not the case. These guys work really hard, and they deserve every penny they get. But this is a guy, he's not even a rancher, he's a welder. He had 8 acres out in Wyoming. And for those of you who are living in 200-square-foot apartments, that is not a lot of land, especially if you're living out in the middle of nowhere in Wyoming. So this is a welder. He builds a pond on his property. Now, he went through all the local and state permits, had absolutely no problem. They gave him permission. And then, for some reason, after the fact, the EPA came in and said, you know what, we've got an issue with that, and we want you to shut this down. And it's like, well, I'm not really sure that you've got jurisdiction here. It's not a problem with anything. This is a swimming pool for my kids. I've got a couple of cows, some livestock here. They're using it to drink from. So the EPA came in and said, no, we're going to shut this down. We own all water in the country, not just the water that's crossing state lines. Not just the large rivers and streams. No, you build a pond on your private property. The EPA says they can control what you do with your private property, even if it's just a pond that you construct on your property. So they came after him with excessive fines as prohibited in the Constitution. Remember that? Remember? There's prohibitions of excessive fines. And that is a prohibition even after you've been found guilty of a crime. No, they put the excessive fines on you before they find you guilty of anything. They were coming after him for $37,500 a day. A guy who's a welder, has 8 acres, and put a little pond on it. They tried to fine him $37,500 a day. Why not $37,501? I mean, it's totally arbitrary, totally excessive, totally unconstitutional, illegal, and criminal, but that's our EPA. That's the out-of-control, unaccountable federal bureaucracy that we have. And they even tried at one point to garnish his wages. They were going to leave the man penniless, just like the IRS does when they say that you owe them money without due process. And then you have to prove your innocence. Say, that's the way they operate. They treat him as if he was some kind of a racketeering and influence corrupt organization where you got to steal the money first so the person can't defend themselves in court and completely destroy their lives. Well, first the EPA was slapped down. Somebody with some sense somewhere said, no, you can't garnish his wages. This is a fine. You haven't found him guilty of anything. He hasn't had any due process. Now they have gone back, and the lawyers who have represented him have worked out a deal with the EPA. And I guess that's a victory. But, you know, when I look at this, I don't really feel like it's a victory in the sense that they give him conditions on what he has to do. They say on one part of it, he's got to plant willows around the pond, temporarily fence off part of it from livestock and so forth. It's like, no. It's none of your business. You don't have any jurisdiction here, EPA. You don't have any jurisdiction. When we admit that you have jurisdiction here, we've lost. It's not really a victory. It's a victory in the sense that they've taken these fines away. And, of course, there is no pragmatic reason, no practical reason for why the EPA would do this. As part of the fight, he went in and he tested water before it came in and came out of his pond, and it was actually cleaner after it came out of his pond. But that's not the point. Doesn't have anything to do with that. It has to do with the fact that they are assuming powers that they don't have. And if you want to know just how bad this is, I've got another story here. The U.S. Supreme Court, this is reported by Reuters, I think it was on Drudge, rejected a challenge to protest, rejected a challenge that on the protest ban that the Supreme Court has put on their plaza. Now think about that, okay? The Supreme Court has banned any kind of protests anywhere close to the Supreme Court building where they hear cases, where they issue rulings. How about that? They say they've got a law that they passed, and the law has made it unlawful to, quote, parade, stand, or move in processions or assemblages in the Supreme Court building or on the grounds, or to display in the building and grounds a flag, a banner, or a device designed or adapted to bring into public notice a party, organization, or movement. I'm like, well, gee, I thought I remembered we had a constitution. And the very first amendment to the constitution said, Congress shall make no law. Oh, you got a law saying we can't parade or make assemblies or put up signs or flags or banners around the Supreme Court? Isn't that kind of ironic? No, it's criminal. It's criminal. The Supreme Court, which routinely exceeds its authority and destroys the Constitution in the name of constitutional review. These people are out there saying, and remember, the Supreme Court says, Congress shall make no law. And they talk about suppressing the free exercise of religion, not just your personal beliefs, but the exercise of religion, the freedom of the press, and then this, the right of the people to peacefully assemble, to petition their government, to redress their grievances. Okay? Congress shall make no law. The Supreme Court shall make no law. The Supreme Court shall have no ban as they're sitting there pontificating about how they're going to change our Constitution. They shut down all free speech around the Supreme Court. Isn't that wonderful? Isn't that wonderful? That's how deep we are into this. That's the insanity. That's why we have to cut off Washington. It's too far gone, folks. It's too far gone. Let's go to Jeremy in California. Jeremy, you had a comment about the report we did on BLM. Go ahead.
Yeah, David, I just want to say quickly, give me a few seconds, too.
Sure.
I am really appreciative of how you have covered this story. I think that you have been probably the best in educating people, covering, putting, tying Harry Reid into everything, tying it into Oregon, being fair with the Bundys. And I'm hugely appreciative of that and InfoWars. I would like to ask, though, for you to take it a step further, because really, I don't know what the difference between, say, you and Pete Santilli was on the ground in Nevada, just two different mic flags and two different approaches. But the truth is that you were on the front lines, David, and that there could be an indictment for you. And so my question is twofold. One, would you, and if Alex is listening right now, Alex, would you send David to go interview Pete Santilli in jail and cover him and cover an alternative media figure? Two, would you please, at a minimum, have his partner and co-host, Deb Jordan, on for an interview about the entire situation. Well, because
let me tell you, Jeremy, you know, maybe like you said, you weren't there. You weren't there at either one of these events. We were there both of the events. And I can tell you, we tried very hard to try to talk to Ammon Bundy and the Oregon situation. And it was Pete Santilli who was running interference for that. So, you know, we were able to talk to Lavoie Finicum when he came out front. My son interviewed him. We've got somebody else here with the Voice of Idaho that I've talked to who's now been arrested on a weapons charge. I don't know if that's legitimate or not. I've seen all kinds of trumped up charges and the indictment against the Bundys. I'm far more interested about the Bundys. I think that is a far more interesting case. And when we look at what happened with the Bundys, they are entrapping the Bundys using what this reporter did. And I have a real problem with that because I don't believe that he acted strictly as a reporter. I believe that he entrapped the Bundys with what he did. And that's what you see in the indictment. There's a lot of lies in that indictment. But what they're doing is they're saying he was their spokesperson. And if he made threats against officers, that was coming from Cliven Bundy. I don't think that's true. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight. And this Tuesday, May 17th, 2016, we're going to go to Mark in North Carolina in just a moment. He has a comment about stealing the election. I do have some news here about something that is happening in North Carolina with voting. Before we do, I just want to remind you that we have our free Alex Jones Insider newsletter. If you sign up for that, of course, it's completely free. You can stay connected to InfoWars. We'll let you know when we've got events coming up, as well as give you exclusive information and content that you'll only see at that newsletter. Also, we do have back in stock Vitamin Mineral Fusion. That's our drink mix that is a multivitamin supply. In one canister, you get a full month supply of essential vitamins, minerals, and amino acids. It is the platinum standard of multivitamin products, and it tastes great. I love to be able to drink my supplements. All that to help you support your health, your family's health, and help support our operation. So check out the products that we have at InfoWarsLife.com. A lot of things that have been out of stock are now back in stock. We have Anthroplex. We have Secret 12, the vitamin B12 formulation. Those are now back in stock, along with Vitamin Mineral Fusion Drink, which sold out very quickly when we first introduced it. I want to go to North Carolina before we do, and I want to see if Mark has a comment on this, because I just saw this story today. Ben & Jerry's is creating a new flavor to promote voting rights in North Carolina, along with the NAACP. Now, they say that they want to protest against, and I don't see anything about the new flavor of ice cream. I don't know what they're going to call it. They say Ben & Jerry's has created a new ice cream flavor as part of a new campaign with the North Carolina NAACP to highlight voting rights, to get money, and to get money out of politics. They're going to have a press conference today. I guess that's when they'll tell us what they're going to call it. Well, I would suggest, I got some names I could come up with that are a bit rude, but you know what? Here's the problem. They want to say that there isn't any problem in North Carolina. I used to live in North Carolina. I used to vote in North Carolina. I would walk in. They would just ask me for my name. They would look it up on their address list and hand me something. They wouldn't verify my identity whatsoever. And I can tell you, and I have told you, back in 2012, my brother-in-law told me that a friend of his went in and said, I went to vote. And they said, well, you've already voted. He says, no, I haven't. He says, yes, you and this other person at your address. And they gave him the name. He goes, that's my mother. She died several years ago. They said, well, you both have voted already. You can't vote. And I said, I want to talk to this guy. I want him to come on the show. He wouldn't come on the show. He didn't protest. And so it didn't happen. You know what? People get raped and they don't file charges sometimes. Okay? So just because they haven't seen these things happen doesn't mean that it hasn't happened. I know for a fact that it has happened. And when you make fraud available to people and you say, we're not going to look at your driver's license, how is that an intimidation that is a civil rights issue? How is that intimidating black people any more than it's intimidating anybody else? It doesn't intimidate people. People are asking you for your identity all the time. Why shouldn't you have to show your driver's license or some kind of a photo ID in order to vote so they can verify that you are who you say you are? There's absolutely nothing discriminatory about that. And there are many states that do it all over the country, and yet they focus on North Carolina because they have a different issue that they want to bring this in. Let's go to Mark in North Carolina. You said stealing the election. Go ahead.
Yes, sir. You know, we talked about him stealing the election, you know, through the primaries and what have you, you know, for the, with the delegates and what have you. What are your thoughts about
instead of the election, you know, after, say it's Hillary and Trump, and the Electoral College gives Hillary the presidency. It's my understanding that Electoral College is supposed to vote the way their state and their
president. Yeah, that brings up an issue, doesn't it? You know, we've started playing these semantic games when we would have elections and we'd say, well, you know, Trump got this many delegates and Cruz got that many delegates. And then they come back and say, oh, no, Cruz took over Trump's delegates. It's like, what? You know, that's a first, isn't it? You know, the reality is that these Electoral College delegates can switch their vote. As a matter of fact, it happened once. We have it's kind of a little bit of a historical trivia that the very first woman who ever got an electoral vote for vice presidency was a Libertarian Party candidate, Toni Nathan. And she was the VP candidate on a presidential campaign. And there was a guy, his name was Roger McBride. He was a Republican delegate to the Electoral College. I forget where it was from. He was also descended from the people that did Little House on the Prairie. That was his mother, grandmother, something. Anyway, he was a producer. And he went to the Electoral College, and instead of voting for whoever it was, I don't know if it was Reagan or whoever, he voted for the Libertarian. And, of course, that was the end of his Republican involvement when he did that. But here's the reality. You can do that. Okay? So people can do that at these conventions. The delegates can switch their votes. And I have a problem. I don't know how you feel about it, Mark, but I have a problem when I vote for somebody and they get awarded the delegates like Trump did, and then they say, well, they're not going to be loyal to Trump. They're not going to support Trump. How do you feel about that?
Well, you know, I feel like I think the Electoral College was put in there to keep the power with the rich, you know, with the people with the money.
Okay, well, yeah, we'll talk about that. There's problems with anything in terms of its implementation. When we come back, I'll talk briefly about why I think the Electoral College is still a good idea. Stay with us. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight. We're going to go to our callers that are on hold in just a moment. Before we do, I want to finish up with what I was talking. The question that the last caller we had, Mark in North Carolina, asked about the Electoral College. What good is it, he says? Well, there is a good reason to have it, even though, like anything else. Look, we need to have a constitution or some kind of a legal structure for our government. We need to have a Bill of Rights, even if the government ignores it, subverts it, as I was talking about with the Supreme Court. So, yeah. The idea behind the Electoral College is a very simple one, and it's a better idea than simply having direct democracy. If we go to just a overall vote, what's going to happen if you've got corrupt areas like Chicago rigging and stuffing the ballot? They could wipe out, in a large city like that, they could wipe out the votes of entire states. And so the whole point of the Electoral College was to give some kind of power to the states. Remember, the states created the federal government. They are not creatures or subdivisions of the federal government. They created the federal government in the same way that, unfortunately, we had nation states create the United Nations. What if the United Nations at some point, which they will, comes out and says, we're going to dissolve the nation states. These things are obsolete. We've already got people who have talked about it. Yesterday on the fourth hour, I talked about it on the nightly news last night. This guy writing op-ed pieces in the New York Times, former and current CFR guy, Council on Foreign Relations, saying we need to get over this antiquated structure of 50 states, and we need to go with regional organizations. We need to reorganize within the United States and across international boundaries between the United States and Canada, for example, create a Detroit-Windsor region. Okay, they're talking about a North American Union. They're talking about dissolving the states because they said, well, we don't need to have these states as subdivisions of this federal government and not even a federal government of the North American Union. But look, going back to the Constitution and where this is all coming from, the states created the federal government. The states wanted to make sure that they had some say-so, that there was a division of power. The thing that they feared the most was the concentration of all power in the federal government. And so that's why you had things like the Ninth Amendment, like the Tenth Amendment. That's why you have the Electoral College. The Electoral College gives a certain number of votes to each state. And then those electors go. And so it's basically a winner-take-all, state by state. And then you have some sort of regional representation that way. That was the purpose of it. And, of course, the delegates can go rogue and they can vote however they wish. But any system can be subverted. And I'll give you an example of what happens, and I've mentioned this once before. In the county where we lived, they used to have county commissioners appointed by each region. And so you'd have a geographical distribution of these county commissioners, and each geographical area of the county would elect a county commissioner. And it was a very rural county. A lot of the people had been there many generations farming the land. And then they had people from a nearby university community, very liberal, start come into this county. And they started, it was a large concentration of people in one corner of the county. And they said, well, we want to get rid of the geographical election of county commissioners, and we want to elect them at large. That means that everybody in the county gets the same slate of people, regardless of where you live. What happened was these people that had the concentration of population in the northeast corner of the county elected all of the county commissioners. They all came from that little area, and they all had an idea. They had an idea that they were going to tell these people who had farms everything that they could and could not do with their land, even though they'd had it for generations. And so that's what's going to happen on a national level if you get rid of the Electoral College. Yeah, it's not a perfect system, but it is a far better system than direct democracy, than direct election, because you're going to have these urban centers who already, because things are set up on a proportional basis by population, they already have a disproportionate say in the election. They are going to have the entire election if you go to that. And of course, tomorrow we've got another election in Oregon and Kentucky. People are saying, hey, it looks like Bernie Sanders is going to have two more victories. And however, in Kentucky, there are strong institutional roots among the Democrats to support Hillary Clinton. I thought, oh, that's really kind of interesting. You know, this article that we got up on Infowars.com from the LA Times, Hillary Clinton keeps losing, so how come she's winning with the delegates? You know, look, people say there's no difference between the Democrats and Republicans. Well, that's simply not true. There's a very clear difference between the Democrats and Republicans. The Democrats steal the nomination before the election, and the Republicans steal the nomination after the election. They do it at the convention, at the brokered convention. The Democrats steal it before the election with the superdelegates, and that, of course, is what they've been doing. And if you go back and you look at what they did with these superdelegates, I remember the last election we had, I think it was West Virginia. Yeah, West Virginia. Okay. Hillary lost to Bernie Sanders. He beat her 51-36. Big spread there, right? Except it's not a winner take all. And they do everything proportionally. So they got the delegates divvied up proportionally. But he still didn't win. Okay. When I first saw it reported, they had it at the end of the night. They said, well, it's 17-17. Now, that isn't that interesting. And the only reason that's happening is because the superdelegates are already there for Hillary Clinton. She gets about 10 to 12% of the delegates out of all these states are superdelegates. So he has to beat her by far more than 10%, which he did. He beat her by about 15%. But they still wound up getting about the same number of delegates. And here's what's even more interesting is the way it was reported. As I said, that night, I took a screenshot of it. I tweeted it out. Said, look at this, 17-17 is the way CNN is reporting it in terms of delegates, even though the spread is 51-36. And then the next day, it shows up as Sanders having 18 and Clinton having 11. It's like, how'd she lose six delegates? It's like, well, you know what's going on. They decided the next day to make it look better, they wouldn't report the superdelegate total. So when you get the superdelegate, when the dust settles out and they allocate all the delegates and they give her the superdelegates out of that state, it wasn't 17-17. It wasn't 18-11. It was 19-18. So he beats her by 15%, and he gets one more delegate than she gets. And he's not going to win. She is only 143 away from the magic number that she needs to have a majority. That's 50% plus one. And that's only 143 delegates. They have a lot more delegates in the Democrat Party than they do in the Republican Party. It's like two different currencies. They have about twice the number of delegates as they do in the Republican Party. So that would be equivalent to saying that Trump only needed about 60 or 70 delegates in order to seal up the election. It's going to happen. And so, there's a difference in the way that they rigged the election, how they set this up. She started out, before the election even began, she started out 15% of the way there with superdelegates who had already pledged to her. And when I was in North Carolina, I tried to interview a guy who was a Bernie Sanders supporter at the university there. And he was very upset, had put some stuff out on Facebook talking about how They had tried numerous things that had been sabotaged by Democrat Party operatives in the state of North Carolina. They kept trying to organize things, and things kept getting shut down, or other things would happen. And his suspicion was that these people were doing things for Hillary Clinton, even though they were supposed to be working for Bernie Sanders. They were doing things for the Clinton organization because they were career Democrats, and they knew where their bread was going to be buttered in the future, and they were going to play along with the system. And so that's the way that works. Let's go to Deborah in Ohio. You also want to talk about the Bundy Ranch. Go ahead, Deborah.
Hi, how are you today?
Doing good.
Good, I'm glad to hear. Listen, you know, usually I'm not a caller. I'm not someone who calls in. But I did want to get something off my mind here because it's really been bothering me. And it's about your coverage not about your coverage. It doesn't matter whether you cover it or not. And that is the subject of Pete Santilli. I am his co-host. And I want to tell you something, Mr. Knight, and I love the work that you do. Actually, Pete has called you an American hero on our show many, many times.
Well, that's not what he was saying at the Bundy Ranch, quite frankly. You know, I hear one thing and I see another thing. And, you know, this is about a lot of things that he's tried to make himself at the center of all this. And this is, I think, a key issue of the problem. And I'm just not interested in talking about him and building him up. That seems to be what he's doing. And he's gotten himself and a lot of other people in a lot of trouble by making himself the center of the issue. So that's really all I've got to say about it. And if you want to keep calling me about it, the issue here is land. It's not a reporter somewhere. Okay? It's about land. It's about an out-of-control government. And when anybody makes themselves a story, that changes the whole dynamic. And I'm not interested in talking about that. I mean, we've got other people who are in trouble. I'm far more interested in talking to the Bundys themselves. I'm far more interested in talking to Ammon and others. And basically, a lot of those lines of communication appear to have been burned by a guy who made himself the center of everything. When I first went there, he said, hey, I'm the liaison between alternative media and the government. I'm not alternative media. I don't need a liaison. I talk to people that I want to talk to when I want to talk to them. I don't need anybody's permission to do it. Nobody represents me, and he didn't represent them. And if he did, it was very foolish on their part. Let's go to our next caller, Rob in New York. Go ahead, Rob.
Mr. Knight.
Yes.
How are you doing today?
Doing good. Go ahead.
Okay, so the reason for my call in, David, is that I wanted to pass along an article for you guys so that way you could potentially really use this. I think it's very interesting. It has to do, obviously, with Mr. Zuckerberg and the virtual reality glasses that are coming out. If I could, is there a email that I could send this to, maybe?
Sure, send it to me at davidk@infowars.com. You're talking about Oculus Rift, right?
Yep, basically.
And I've seen the pictures of people sitting there, you know, crowds of people with these giant goggles on. And, you know, it truly is literally becoming like the Matrix. And I've tried them on myself. It's a very impressive thing. And it's a very dangerous thing, too. You know, we need to understand, just as we talk about technology, just because you can build something doesn't mean you should do it. We talked about that when we talked about synthetic DNA. The other day, talked about it on Sunday, the fact that they could construct children, designer children, wherever they want to do it. And there's a picture you can see pull up there. They pulled up a picture of this crowd of people sitting there, wired into the Matrix, literally. You know, when we're talking about scientists and we say just because they can construct a human being from scratch and they can build a super soldier that they can then program and control after program it from birth and program from before birth, they shouldn't do it. Just because you can do something doesn't mean you should do it. And just because something is entertaining and engaging, like this virtual reality Oculus Rift, I think we need to understand the dangers involved in it. I mean, this is something that has a potential to be like a drug to people because it is so engaging. And so just as I don't support drug prohibition because I don't think it works, I also don't support drug use, okay? I don't use drugs. I don't drink. And I think it's a wise thing to just abstain from some of these things that can really suck you in, can waste your life, destroy your time, and make you helpless and dependent. Your comments, Rob.
That's the beauty of this article, David, is that the inventor and founder, Palmer Luckey, was actually caught in a suspicious ring of burglaries due to this.
Mm.
And one of the golden points, I'm not going to take up too much more time, but one of the golden points is at the end when the police said when asked how he exactly or when he knew exactly when the victims were using VR, Luckey simply stated, "We're owned by Facebook."
Wow. Wow. Yeah, send me that article. I'd like to see that. Sounds like a great article. Thank you for passing that on. Let me go quickly to John in Wyoming. John, go ahead.
Hi, David.
Hi.
Can you hear me?
Yes. You're on. Go ahead.
Okay. You're right on the Electoral College issue because, look, Wyoming is the least populous state in the Union. We have about 568,000 people. California, on the other hand, has well over 38 million. So right now they have 55 electoral votes and we have three. So they outnumber us 18 and a third to one. However, if we went to a direct democracy, they would outnumber us 67.4 to one.
Exactly.
So the founding fathers gave us the Electoral College to protect the rural areas from the excesses of big cities and big populated states in the Northeast.
Exactly.
That's the whole point.
Yeah.
The Electoral College is there to protect our vote, not to destroy it.
And not only just to protect rural interests against urban interests, but to protect state interests, because it was the states that created the federal government. They were sovereign states at the time they created the federal government, and they wanted to make sure that they did not lose that sovereignty. They gave limited powers to the federal government, and they made it very, very clear. In the Ninth and the Tenth Amendment, they said, if we don't explicitly give you these powers, you don't have them. And we have to enumerate anything that we give you. It has to be enumerated very specifically. That's why we have an amendment that said that they had the power to prohibit alcohol. But now they prohibit everything unless it's expressly permitted. And that includes prescription drugs, not just things like marijuana. Where is the amendment to prohibit marijuana or to prohibit some prescription drug? They never did it. They just assumed the power. In the same way, they said, we're going to pass an amendment to have an income tax. And yet now we're told that the unconstitutional mandates to purchase insurance are simply a tax. Well, that wouldn't be constitutional either. And so, yeah, they ignore the Constitution, but that's the whole point, was to keep the power at the states. One of the things that they did, of course, one of the amendments that they did that helped to destroy the division of power. And when we talk about this, folks, I know that when you talk about states having power, it triggers people. It's like, you're talking about states' rights, therefore you're talking about racism and slavery. No, we're talking about a division of power. Power was supposed to be divided to keep it from being consolidated. They all understood the greatest danger was the consolidation of power. And so I pointed out yesterday when I played the 8 points from Boris Johnson, former mayor of London, who is advocating that Britain leave the European Union. He said, here's 8 reasons why we should leave. And most of those reasons were the same reasons that we've seen here abused in the United States. Too much consolidation of power. Money is going away from us. Power is flowing away from us. Everything is going into a distant government that we have no say-so. We have very little control over, if any, and we don't get to make the decisions locally. The better the government, the more local the government, or the more local, the better the government. Should put it that way. If government is local, it's more easily controlled. You look at a situation like New Hampshire. They have more representatives there, the largest legislative body that they have anywhere in the world. And I remember a few years ago, I guess it was a few years ago, 20 years ago, 25 years ago, when the Libertarian Party, we had 4 Libertarians got elected into the House at one point of New Hampshire. And they said, yeah, if you spend more than $1,000 trying to get elected to the New Hampshire House at the time, you're accused of trying to buy the election. It's like, wow, because in North Carolina at the time, they were spending about $50,000 to get elected to the legislature, because that's where the corruption comes in. You give people power, the money will flow to that power. You're not going to do, you know, Ben and Jerry and the NAACP say, well, you know, we want to get money out of politics and everything. Well, get the power out of politics and the money will go somewhere else. The problem is that we've got too much power concentrated into one place, and like a black hole, It is sucking all of the life and the light and the oxygen. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host. I want to talk about this 9/11 bill, because there was a very, very, in the article, was a very interesting comment from Paul Ryan, which I think needs to be fleshed out. Before we go back to that, and before I go back to Dave in South Carolina, hang on there, Dave. I just want to let you know that we have some of the products that have been sold out. We introduced Vitamin Mineral Fusion, and that's a drink mix that we have at InfoWarsLife.com. We put that out, and it very quickly sold out of our first limited run. We now have it back again in stock, but it will sell out very quickly at the rate that it is moving. It's a great-tasting Vitamin Mineral Fusion drink. It is in each of these containers, you'll get 1 month's worth of supplies of essential vitamins, minerals. You don't have to take a bunch of pills. I really like being able to drink my vitamin supplements, and it has a great deal of ingredients. Vitamin C, vitamin E, zinc, magnesium, selenium, L-glutamine, alpha lipoic acid, folic acid, calcium, many others. You can look at InfoWarsLife.com and see what's there. That's now back in stock. Get it while it is still available. Also, Anthroplex is now back in stock, another relatively new product. I think this is our second run of Anthroplex. It sold out very quickly as well. It is now back in stock as well. I want to go to our caller, Dave in South Carolina, real quickly. But before I do, I just want to mention this. And this bill from this article about the Senate bill allowing 9/11 victims to sue Saudi Arabia. I have a comment from Paul Ryan. He says, I think we need to look at it. I think we need to review it, because we need to make sure we're not making mistakes with our allies, and we're not catching people that shouldn't be caught up in this. And I said it created a rare area of agreement between GOP lawmakers and the White House. It's like, no, it's not rare. Paul Ryan agrees with Obama on the borders. He agrees with him on the trade issues, that were the trade deals that were written by multinational corporations without any input from our legislators. He's going to oppose Donald Trump, Paul Ryan will, more than he opposes Obama. I can guarantee that. It's one of the reasons why he needs to be primaried out. He's got a primary coming up in August, and we need to make sure that he doesn't return to the House, because he is going to be the biggest obstacle a President Trump would face. He agrees with Obama on all of these issues. And we talk about we don't want to unjustly come after our allies. I've got this article we don't have time to talk about from The Guardian. I'll talk about tonight on the nightly news. This lady talking about the 50 lashes that her husband got. He was sentenced to 1,000 lashes. He's gotten the first 50, nearly killed him. He's been sentenced to 10 years in prison and 1,000 lashes. What was his crime? Well, he blogged about things and insulted Islam, quote, through electronic channels, according to the Saudi government. This government that cuts off more heads than ISIS does is our closest ally. These are the people that Paul Ryan and Obama are protecting, trying to keep their involvement in 9/11 quiet. Absolutely criminal. Let's go to Dave in South Carolina. Dave, go ahead.
David, I really appreciate what you bring to Alex's organization on a daily basis. It's been a fantastic addition.
We've only got about a minute. Go ahead.
In principle with your voter discrimination thing, but technically I will disagree in that voter identification is to be discriminatory, but not against race, but against those who are not legitimate voters. It is designed to protect the system to be discriminatory.
Yes, yes, exactly. Yeah, there are some legitimate forms of discrimination, and we forget that. You know, when Obama says we can't discriminate against people when we rent to them in case they're felons, you know what? If you have, as government, convicted somebody of murder and rape, and then you turn them out and say, well, I think they're all better now, I think I have a right to discriminate against what that person has done, that you have certified that that person has done, because you put them in prison and then you release them. I need to know that information, and we can discriminate against people based on what they do. That's not wrong to do that. Join us tonight, 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern, for the InfoWars Nightly News.